Hello. This is Rosen Island.
What?
That was pretty
good. I'm one of the winners of the publisher's clearinghouse. Ed McMahon wants to see me right away.
Hey, I have to apologize. I thought this was the Joe Franklin studio. I'll tell you why I'm here. I happen to be in town over doing some stuff for the NBC affiliate.
That's right.
And, you know, Ed McMahon, our good friend, could not be here. Yeah. But it seems, David, that you are the $1 million winner.
Oh, my God! I've won $1 million!
Shout out to my people. This is Ed McMahon, rolling slow through the suburbs in an unmarked van. I ran the strip in the 80s, brought big fat checks to the ladies. When I showed up at their door, they would start screaming like crazy. Raked it in hand over fist, was on the VIP list. I was a verbal gunslinger, and my shots never miss. But now the bills have come due, and my credit score's whacked. So I'm hitting up the winners to get my checks back.
Hi, Ed McMahon, remember I gave you that big check? I'd like to have that check back. I'm having some stuff would help a lot. Just a little bit.
Because, you know, and I knew, you know, the difference in the situation was I knew you were making bank on those shirts. You know, I knew you were bright.
I did okay.
Yeah. You look like the Monopoly guy. You're driving from town to town in a black top hat and a monocle.
I remember they started bootlegging that just to quickly talk about me for a second.
I'll never join you!
If you only knew the power of the dark side.
When I first saw the dialogue that said, "Luke, I am your father," I said to myself, he's lying. I wonder how they're gonna play that lie out.
Obi-Wan never told you what happened to your father.
He told me enough. He told me you killed him.
No, I am your father.
Say what?
Who's the baldest of them all?
I see a red door and I want to paint it black. It's the city I live in, the city of angels, the loneliest I am to ever cry.
All right, welcome back to Dose of Reality. Let me just get my little thing up there. Yeah, so got a few things to talk about. Thank you, everybody that's here. I appreciate everybody coming over. As you guys probably all know, if you're here, this is where we're doing shows live for at least a little over a month, at least like a month and a half. We'll be doing shows live here, okay? I did mirror some of the videos we did live here on the main, but most of them I haven't, just because. So, you know, make sure you're subbed and belled to this channel. That's where everything's going to be. Basically, I mean, you can tell by the title what's going down. I had another huge, let me bring the chat up so I can see it. Yeah, thank you, everybody. Thank you. I had another, it's crazy. You know, No One's Flower came and visited me the other day. And I put the video up of when we went to the sign and, you know, the Centerville sign, now Centralville, has the fucking, you know, American flag the old way we remember it on the sign with the new spelling of the neighborhood, right? Underneath it, it had the red stripe like we remember. But now they went and planted a bunch of flags on the ground around there and stuff because it's a veterans park also right next to it and behind it and all around it. And all these other flags don't match the monuments flag because they're all the new reality. And then we go across the street to the Top Donut. And I'm looking at all the old paintings looking for Centerville residue, right? And there's a business with the Merrimack residue because the Merrimack River and the Merrimack now has, you know, a CK instead of just a C on it. So it's real crazy. One story I didn't even get into either, and I'll get into it now. I don't give a fuck if they want to give me a strike, whatever. They can fight me. All right, I'm going to say what I need to say. So we were sitting in the diner, and we were talking about all the hoax events, like the one in Boston, for instance, is the one we were talking about for a while. And then we got into how it wasn't just like these people that are just like caught up in the drama of the whole thing, making T-shirts and stuff. Like those Boston Strong shirts were put out by, you know, Nike put a ton of them out and still do. They sell them at the Nike outlet and in Merrimack, as a matter of fact, Merrimack outlets with the CK now instead of just the C. They sell those Boston Strong shirts. So we were talking about that, me and Nora were, literally for like, you know, maybe 10, 15 minutes. And we were talking about that whole type of topic for longer than that, you know, during the whole breakfast. We were talking about those type of things. And specifically the Boston Strong shirt. And while we were talking, she was talking about how those events that happened a few weeks ago, you know, that always happened, even though nobody would ever really do that. And a couple of them popped up within a couple of days. And she had made some references to, like, she was in areas where, you know, they were or a suspect was from or whatever at each one. She's like, wouldn't it be freaky if, like, something happened here right now or something? I'm like, yeah, you know, because, you know, as much as you say things can't follow you, like what I'm talking about with my town, right? So we go to, literally, we get up and we get in the Uber or the Lyft or whatever it was, and we leave the Owl Diner. And I forgot to tell this part of the story. So we leave the Owl Diner and the Uber or the Lyft, and we're on our way over to Top Donut, directly across the street from the infamous sign. And as we pull into the Top Donut, because we always talk about this reality and what is it, and we don't fucking know, right? Are there things just inserted in this reality? I talk about it being a test. I say I know I'm not a simulation. You know, I don't know about everything else. I don't know yet because I know so much. Look at all the stuff in the sky that they fake. I mean, everything. You know, where does it end? You don't know. So we're talking about the Boston Strong shirts for a long time. She was talking about people at the company and all sorts of shit. As soon as we pull in the Top Donut, I look over. This fucking guy comes out of nowhere, dude. Out of fucking nowhere. He's got the door halfway open as I see him already. Boom. Boston Strong shirt. I'm like, do you see that? She's like, yeah, you see what I'm talking about? I'm like, what the fuck, dude? And then all this shit happened with the neighborhood. Right, which I'm not going to go through it all again because I did it last show. So if you missed it, you're going to have to go watch it. I can show some of the images again today. That's fine. But let's get to the new stuff. So as you know, here in Lowell, Ed McMahon, I mean, not even just for Lowell. I mean, Ed McMahon, I'm being honest when I say this, not biased. In fact, Black Tom is my number one, not Ed McMahon, but he's like my number three. He could be number one. But as you guys know, I talk to tons of people. People call the show on Facebook, talking to everybody about Mandela Effect for years. I always ask people what their number one is, how they found the channel. Nothing is even close to having as many number one votes as Ed McMahon. Now, Ed McMahon is from Lowell. But there's another celebrity from Lowell, not anywhere near the level of Ed McMahon on an athletic level. He was known, but also people around the nation might know this guy because there was a very popular movie with Christian Bale and Marky Mark, and it was all filmed in Lowell. In fact, I have pictures of them going down East Merrimack Street filming it. Okay, with the don't even get me going on Merrimack, and it's about a boxer named Mickey Ward and his brother Dickie Eklund. And they also have a series on HBO called High on Crack Street. This was way before the movie, but the movie's called The Fighter. Blockbuster movie, really, really good movie, honestly. I don't suggest many movies, but this was a fucking awesome movie, not just because I live alone and I see a lot of things I recognize. I mean, Christian Bale is not a small actor. I mean, they probably paid him fucking $20 million to do the movie. And Marky Mark's like, you know, he's making money like The Rock, for Christ's sakes. But not Ben when he made this, but it's a really, really good movie. And the crazy part is it's about a boxer named Mickey Ward and Dickie Eklund, the movie. All right. And Mickey Ward was known for The Fight of the Century, which was what they were nicknaming it because he had a trilogy with Arturo Gatti. It was legendary in boxing. They just went out there and beat the shit out of each other. Like crazy, 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 right? I want to show you something. Check this out. I'm going to share my screen real quick. Whoops, hang on. So this is him right here. I don't know if you guys recognize this guy. Mickey Ward. All right. It does not like, you know, number one heavyweight champion. I mean, he's a middleweight or a flyweight, whatever the hell he is. He's light, but he's from Lowell. He's nowhere near Ed McMahon, but he's a hero around here. And around the year 2000, you know, I mean, this is when he was going, and these fights were huge. They were huge fights, and they were talked about all over the boxing world, all over, you know, ESPN and everywhere. We're going to get into that, though. So Mickey Ward, you see him right there, right? Mickey Ward had a movie made about him. Big budget movie. Christian Bale, Marky Mark. Christian Bale played the brother. Marky Mark played Mickey Ward. It's called The Fighter. Not only based in Lowell, the whole thing is pretty much shot here. I mean, it's literally shot in all these places that I know. Okay. Mickey Ward, there he is. That's how I know him. Now, somebody brought this up to me, and the person's name was Vicky. I don't know the last name is on Facebook, so credit to Vicky. Mickey Ward is now Mickey with no E. He lost the E in his name. Now, I'm going to show you. When I get to the residue on this one, it's fucking substantial, okay? Mickey Ward lost the E in his name. Now it's Mickey. Who the fuck spells Mickey like that? And again, I mean, the guys from here, if his name Mickey was spelled like that crazy fucking way, I would remember that. Now let's get into some more, shall we? Let's get into some residue. Mickey Ward, CBS. This is CBS Boston. This isn't just some fucking random guy on the internet's blog, somebody misspelling shit that doesn't have to put shit through a spell checker. This is people that have huge editing teams. Here's his brother Dickie in real life, not Christian Bale, obviously, but Christian Bale did a really good job playing. Here's them right here. Here's Christian Bale, Marky Mark, and they're supposed to be these two guys. And right here, Mickey Ward is the title of it with the E. If you scroll down, here's another article about Mickey. Mickey Ward with the E to drop the puck at the Bruins game. Well, you better check the guy's ID because they might be sending the wrong guy because this guy they're sending is just a CKY guy. And I do have to shut some tabs as we go because holy shit, this has bogged my computer down. But I didn't want to have to keep opening links. So I will just click them down as we go. Let me get to the next one. But maybe I won't click them down because it didn't seem to work good. This is ABC. So we saw what? CBS? This is ABC News. Look at right in the URL. Look at this. Mickey. See it? M-I-C-K-E-Y. ABC News. Well, they should research their people before they go out there and, you know, have them on for interviews and shit. Twitter is interesting because watch this. This is good. So when I go on Twitter, right, and I search for Mickey Ward, and Twitter's great for residue. Let me see if I can close a couple windows real quick. Hang on. Close. Thank you. I do have to close a couple as I go because it's just going to bog it. It's bogging it down real bad, but I want to have them already. So check this out. Mikey Adams. This is Mikey Adams. He's been a sports broadcaster in the Boston area like my whole life. He's cool too. I used to really enjoy this guy. All right. WEEI is the sports radio giant in the whole country, not just Boston. They're the number one hugest sports radio station. And their local boxing legend, Mickey Ward. You know, and I'll zoom in. Again, Mickey with the E, as I remember. WEEI, local boxing legend, Mickey Ward. John Wallach, who is another sports radio host there at WEEI, or he might be on the rival channel now. John Wallach. What about Mickey Ward? Ian Rappaport, the Mickey Ward movie, The Fighter, with himself in the movie theater. Oh, he's watching it with Mickey. He's sitting with Mickey watching it. Yeah, no big deal. You just want to spell his name, asshole. Mike Reese, another reporter for the local media, sports media. Coach gave us a treat today. We are watching the Mickey Ward movie with the fighter himself in the movie theater. Oh, so they brought a few people down there. Funk Flex, boxing champ Mickey Ward, hospitalized after brutal attack by dog. Well, who the fuck is Mickey with anyway? Because that guy doesn't exist in this reality, dude. I want to see Thornton fight this Mickey Ward guy. Scott Zolak, former Patriots quarterback, also a sports radio host. WEEI in front of Mickey Ward. Dude, these are the people that cover him his whole life. ESPN Boston, Bruins blog, Mickey Ward to drop ceremonial puck. So they must have just decided, we don't know his name. We're just going to go by what ABC says, and we're going to spell it like this because we're fucking retarded, right? And Brian's crazy, and the Mandela effect isn't real. And no, nothing crazy is going on in Lowell. I mean, we only got Ed McMahon, Mickey Ward, the Merrimack River, Centerville. I mean, what the fuck is going on around here? Toucher and Rich, another one of the shows. Boston's own Joe Lazoon from the UFC at 920. Boxing legend Mickey Ward. Guy, you're going to come out here, call homeboy a legend, and you don't even know how to spell his name? Damn, Gina. Steve Austin. This is literally Stone Cold Steve Austin, by the way, because I do follow him on Twitter. Steve Austin. Hell, son, then go with a Toro Gaudi verse, Irish Mickey Ward. Next page. Oh, the residue is insane. Grandstand Sports. A Toro Gaudi, Mickey Ward autograph merchandise. Now, when we go to the autograph merchandise, Mickey Ward with an EY. How are you going to sell? And I did look at the signature and you can't tell. It's probably without it. I'm sure it changed. I can zoom in if you want. You really can't tell by the picture. I mean, that's just, you know. But look, he's going to put it right here with the EY. You're selling memorabilia for big bucks. And you're going to spell it wrong. These fucking autograph ones I love. There's more. Hang on. Irish Mickey Ward, signed slab, 2011. Look at Sports Integrity, Irish Mickey Ward, EY. Just like any Mickey would be spelled fucking EY. Next. Irish Mickey Ward, the fighter, signed 8x10 photo. But his name isn't Mickey anymore, and it never was. Steiner Auctions. You already know the deal. Mickey Ward, EY. Never existed in this reality, but people are just selling his memorabilia everywhere. Autographed. EY here. Here's a book, More Tales from Ringside by Tom Donaldson. I found it on Google Books, and it's right here about there. Oh, I just said had his name right there, and I just fucking – did I just – well, it was on the screen. You can pause it and go back because it was there and highlighted. If I can't find it, let me see if I refresh that, if it brings it back to where I had the cursor. It does. Ward Gaudi, one more time. Editor's note, Mickey Ward. Look at it. Look at this. Oh, God. God. All right, fuck this window. It's there. You can pause the video yourself. I'm not dealing with that. Be here all night. Let me close this other one. Hey, this is the Lowell Sun. And what is this one? Maybe this one had a double spelling. Because in the headline, it has the CKY. Here it is. In the headline, in the Lowell Sun, it's got the new. And this date is 2016. And then down here, it's got the way I remember. Oh my God, look at this. What the fuck is this? Mickey Ward, now Mickey without the E. So is this not a Mandela effect? What is this? Did this guy officially change his name? Hey, if it happened and I just got fucking busted on one, then hey, it is what it is. I fucking didn't even see that in there. I read this earlier. Dude, no. I read this article earlier. This article just got this fucking update, dude. I wouldn't have fucking done this whole video without... I read this article. It didn't say Mickey Ward, now Mickey without the E. And fucking... Look at this. This just came into this fucking article in the Lowell Sun. I read it earlier because it had the double. It didn't have this in parentheses. Oh my goodness. What is this? That is fucking crazy. All right, on to the next. What the fuck? That was not in that article. And did you see the wordings on that? Now Mickey without the E in parentheses. Like, what the fuck is that, dude? Look at this, Sylvester Stallone, right? Very proud to have Irish Mickey Ward, who is a real-life Rocky, wear this T-shirt. If you want to see some of the grading fights ever, go to YouTube and watch Mickey with the E Ward. What is going on here? How do you spell such a simple name two different ways in one Twitter, a short Twitter post? How does that happen? That article is fucking blowing me away right now, dude. That is crazy. I read that. That wasn't there. And why would his name change? It literally just said now Mickey without the E in the fucking article as we're doing the show. I didn't even call me superstitious or something, but dude, that's fucking creepy right there. That wasn't there. Because if that was there, I would have fucking read it, and when I read it, I would have, like, doubted myself and hesitated to do the video or something. That fucking, and I would have looked into it. That absolutely was not there, but let's continue with all the residue. Mickey Ward, the tale versus Gotti Ward. That's fucking so crazy right now. I don't even know what to think about that. That is so crazy that came in the article. It took a fucking update, and it's so specific to tell you now without the E, bro. Like, really? Like, why don't you just fucking laugh at me, fucking Mandela? That's what it's been doing. I feel like it. It's all the shit happens in Lowell. Mickey Ward, M-I-C-K-E-Y, and this is, what, BoxingMagazine15Rounds.com. Oh, there'll be more significant ones coming. ESPN, Everlast, who he has a sponsorship with. Mickey, E-Y, in the URL. The Fighter. The Fighter is based on true story of boxer Mickey Ward and the struggles he faced along the road. Blah, 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 blah. I'll go open phones after this, too. ESPN. This is ESPN.com. And if you scroll down to here on the right, I saw it right here. Catch Gotti Ward. If you missed the fight between Arturo Gotti and Mickey Ward, Mickey with the EY. Just a few more left. Well, like 7 or 8. Here's Everlast. He wears Everlast gloves. That's what he autographed. Everlast.com. round of the century, Arturo Gatti versus Mickey Ward, 2016. Says it on the video too. Boxing Mind. Arturo Gatti, Mickey Ward, EY. I still can't believe that that said that. That's fucking crazy. Mickey Ward bobblehead, but the product says Mickey with the Y. They write EY right here. Product says CKY. Insanity. It says EY here too in the text. Mickey Ward Irish. Round of the century. On 9ounces.com. I don't know what these sites all are, but this one looks decent. Round of the century. Arturo Gatti versus Mickey Ward. EY. Eastside Boxing. And where is it? It's in here. Arturo Gatti, Mickey Ward, right here. I'll zoom it in. Look at this. CKEY. MMA Linker video, Mickey Ward's brother, Dick Eklund, HBO crack documentary. That's what I was telling you. High on Crack Street, Mickey Ward. Again, Mickey, CKEY. Down here, Mickey, CKEY. But it's CKY. Lowell Sun. Where is it? Right here. Kept in touch with him. I read the new Mickey and Dickie script, now called The Fighter, and fell in love with the story. Mickey with the CKEY again. And Bales head blog, Christian Bales, some sort of site for him. And here it is. Mickey Ward, CKEY. Showing off pecs. Says Mickey Ward right here in the URL, as you can see. Mickey Ward right here, bold and in the title. And in the text, Mickey. Two more links. No, one more. This is the last one. And The Fighter. Look at this. This one's interesting, too. Check this out, right? So this is not a name change. That article took a total update with a total hardcore Mandela backstory. Now, look at this. This moviemistakes.com. It's a popular site. Probably all heard of it. Both spellings in one post. Look at this. Mickey, C-K-E-Y. But in the continuity thing, Mickey, C-K-Y. How does that even happen? That CKY is bothering me. It's never been that, dude. I didn't notice it until this person just told me. And there's so much residue of that. I'm going to close this window down. Shut this crap off. And go back to the chat. What's up, everybody? Yeah, it is crazy, Lumpy. You see all that residue, dude? Come on, man. How does that even happen? It looks stupid now. Who spells their name like that? Come on, man. Lumpy knows. He knows about Centerville. It's fucking crazy, bro. Lumpy, did you see the last show? I went to the fucking Centralville sign. It's got the old American flag on it, the way it used to be, with the red stripe under the blue. But there's all these flags they planted in the ground because it's a veterans park, and all the flags in the ground have the white stripe under the blue like it is in this reality now. I'll show you. Check this out. Hold on. And I'll open the phones in a minute. Would you see this if you didn't see it? Where's my Mandela folder here? Yeah. Centerville. All right, check this out. Look at the red stripe. That's how we remember it. red stripe under the blue. But look at the flag here. White stripe under the blue. And that's how the flags are now everywhere. But we got plenty of residue of this. I mean, you know, it's everywhere. Red, but right here on this sign, where this is wrong for me, this is the new way. This is the old way at the same time. This is right here. And then we found Merrimack with the C in here on the wall on top doing it. When you walk in on the right, there's a picture of it. It's everywhere. Insane. I'm going to open the phones up. Hang on. Let me just shut some of this crap down. All right. And I'll open up the phone lines. What do you guys think about all that residue? That's a lot of residue, right? I mean, that's fucking crazy, bro. Crazy. Yeah, so all the live shows will be here for a bit, if you don't know. Can't risk it on the other one. So we're going to be here. That's the deal. Truth Seeker is going to join me in a little bit tonight. Probably in about an hour or so. So let's keep it going with the phones. Phone lines are open. Call in right now. 978-435-0006. Who's calling in? 978-435-0006. Yeah, so, and I brought it up on yesterday's show with Cynthia Sue Larson. I don't know if you guys heard it. It was a really good show. And, you know, we got kind of into like a deeper conversation about the Mandela effect. But, you know, I asked her and I've asked other people this. I've asked my viewers this. Am I attracting this thing here? And not to sound egotistical or anything. I believe we all attract it to a degree. And I believe it's because we all feed our energy and our information, our consciousness with each other. And if I'm having all these conversations with people about it all the time, then, you know, the chance of it maybe magnifying more or happening here. There's just too much happening here, dude. You could just stop at fucking Ed McMahon. You know what I mean? Dose of reality, you're on, Brian. Who's this?
Yo, it's the craft beer daddy from the Cincinnati.
Who is it?
The craft beer daddy from the Cincinnati.
What's going on?
Oh, just driving home. Yo, yeah, so it's super weird. They got the flags the opposite way at the memorial in your town, the little stone thing.
Yeah.
You know, the opposite way. What's up with that? You think they're just playing a trick on you or what? Because I know there's other people that got Mandela effects in their town, but I mean, it's pretty weird.
Dude, am I, do you think I'm being paranoid? Or do you ever, I have just reason to fucking feel this way, right? Like, it's a little crazy, man.
I mean, I don't know. Don't you feel like pretty paranoid? Like, do you, like, how, like, what's your level of paranoia that you got to live with all the time?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not too paranoid because I really don't have any fear of anything. Like, it really doesn't bother me. I just think it's fascinating, you know? And I want to know. I mean, I want to know. And I honestly, I tend to think it is. I tend to think being here and doing what we're doing, and I just tend to think it's happening more here. It's more things are going to change.
Dang, dude, I'll tell you what. I'll let you go. I'll keep listening to your show, but I can't really hear you for shit. But peace out, dude. I'll let you go. Brother. All right.
All right, man. Yeah, that guy had a bad connection or whatever. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, what do you guys think in the chat? Do you guys think that it because I'm here, it's happening more? I mean, come on, man. How many Mandela effects are going to happen here? Did you see all that residue I just showed? The guy's name was Mickey, not Mickey without an E. And how is the Lowell Sun? How is all these places that cover him, WEI Sports and ABC, CBS, NBC, people Everlast, who he has a contract with, how are they all going to spell his name wrong? Why are all the websites registered to the wrong name? Come on, man. I'm not fucking retarded. How are people selling memorabilia with it spelled one day in the memorabilia and they're spelling it the other way in the fucking text? We know what the deal is. So that shit changed. Speaking of that, do you guys remember when I brought this picture up? Hold on. I'll bring it up again right now. I'm going to go to a full screen share. You guys remember this picture. Let me go to my Centerville folder real quick. Check this out. So I brought up this picture of a dude in a baseball uniform, and it got brought up again in the conversation because when I went with that Uber driver, actually it was a Lyft driver. I called her an Uber driver. When I went with that Lyft driver, she brought up the same story. So this dude, Ryan, I used his picture when I was looking for residue for Centerville. And the reason was obvious. This is his picture when he was little, and he wrote Centerville Royals. But look at his hat. It says Centralville on it. Why the fuck would you write Centerville then? If it's always been Centralville. Just the other day, because I posted some Centerville pictures up again for the first time in a while on Facebook, a whole bunch of them. Just to kind of, you know, trigger people or get them to look. He's like, oh my God, he stopped by the post. He says, look at my hat. I said, yeah, man, that's what I'm trying to say, bro. That's what I'm trying to say. It also spread too, which is very interesting. If people didn't know, and Lumpy, I know you're in the chat. You'll like to hear this one. Check this out, right? So let me get my, where I can see you guys again. So when this happened, I have to be specific to people and tell them, listen, because they keep sending me things from Centerville, Massachusetts. It's not Centerville, Massachusetts. That place still exists. So stop telling me you're Googling it and finding Centerville, Massachusetts. And I understand if you don't know. But it's Centerville, a neighborhood in Lowell. And when it changed businesses that had the name in it, like the Centerville Social Club, and we've made phone calls there, and other people in the audience have made phone calls there. The lady got pretty pissed at me. Her sign now says Centralville. She says Centerville. So then I noticed that looking for residue, there's a place called the Centerville Sportsman's Club, still called Centerville, right? But it's in Drake. And I discussed this in a video. I said, there is a Centerville Sportsman's Club, because I think I came across the residue real quick, and I talked about it. And I said, but I can't use this as residue because that's actually in Drake It, even though that's probably why it has the name, because Centerville used to be part of Drake It. But I'm not going to stretch it like that and call that residue. Since this has happened, now, Lumpy, if you're there, go out to the Centerville Sportsman's Club and Drake It. It's the Centralville Sportsman's Club now. And I talked about in a video how it was still the Centerville. God knows what video and where in the video it is. But I talked about it. That's now Centralville. As is the Methodist Church. The Centerville Methodist Church. Centralville Methodist Church on Bridge Street. When you come up before it goes into Hildreth, the white sign is going to smack you right in the face. It's fucking insane. So what's going on here? I don't know, man. Anybody got any ideas? I'm fucking fresh out of ideas, dude. Somebody call in 978-435-0006. Saw that when I went to the Village Inn in March. You saw which one, Lump? The Centerville Sportsman's Club? Fucking insane, right? How does that happen, dude? It's happening, dude. You know what I mean? People tell me it's a copyright issue. Fuck you, motherfucker. My fucking neighborhood's changing. My neighborhood's changing. People think I'm fucking nuts. And who's this?
Hi, this is Clarice from Niagara Falls. How are you?
Hello, Clarice from Niagara Falls.
Yeah, Niagara. I've seen that.
Yeah, anybody that doesn't know, Niagara Falls never existed. It is now Niagara. That was good. I caught ODD on that one because he had Niagara in his... in his video, and I told you about it. Yeah. So what's up?
Yeah, there's tons of residue on the Niagara Falls stuff. It's all over the place. Anyway, maybe you're like on some kind of weird electromagnetic fault line or something, because so much shit's happening in Centerville. It's really weird.
Yeah, and it's really easy to prove to everybody. I mean, there's so. I mean, you know what I mean. I mean, it's not hard to prove Ed McMahon. We're fucking publishers, clear enough, for Christ's sakes. And the best part is, though, the craziest part is, it's not just a collection of Mandela effects. Don't forget this Centerville thing. It's not everybody saying Centralville, and it's always been that way. Taking the update, everybody still says Centerville. Nobody even knows what Centralville is, even though the sign's in the middle of the road. What the fuck is that?
Yeah, that is just so freaking weird. I mean, because I've been looking it up ever since you first brought it up, like 2 months ago or however long it was.
Yeah.
You know, and it changes almost every time I look it up. It's like really super weird, because at first there was tons and tons of residue, and then it just slowly like drifted away. And like the last thing I seen, it said Centralville, pronounced Centerville. It's like nobody's going to pronounce the name of their city different than what it's spelled.
Yeah.
You know?
And the thing too is, and I didn't get the video from her yet, but when Nora and me parted ways that day, because I had to go to work, she went to City Hall. Now, she's over here from Ireland. You know, she wanted to look. So she went to City Hall to talk to them. She recorded it. I haven't even heard it yet. But they told her exactly what I said they were going to tell. I said, they're going to tell you one or two things. They're going to have no idea what the fuck you're talking about, like the lady when I called, and she just called it Centerville. Or they're going to take an update and tell you it's a mispronunciation. It's exactly what he did. And listen, it's how is it a mispronunciation when we have it in print in the Lowell Sun, in Lowell City Hall records for budget proposals, in police records, in print, Centerville has nothing to do with the pronunciation. It's in print on legal documents.
Yeah, it's just so weird.
And we don't, dude, if Centralville would not be sounding like Centerville, it's not even close to the same, dude. Especially with our accent.
No.
I can't even say Centralville. It makes me want to go kill myself.
God, don't do that.
No, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah. Like the, and that Mickey Ward thing, I was reading about him and his, like his idol, his mentor was this Mickey O'Keefe, some cop.
Yeah, I know. I actually
and his
know
name
guy.
Was spelled, I mean, M-I-C-K-E-Y. Why wouldn't he spell his name the same way if this guy was so freaking important in his life?
It was the same way. And imagine, and you've seen the Lowell Sun article I just came across. Now let's talk about what you just said. If Mickey O'Keefe, and I know Mickey O'Keefe, my dad's a Lowell cop, he's friends with the guy, right? Lumpy met him, I'm sure, too, right? So Mickey O'Keefe's name, if he was a mentor to Mickey Ward, he was training him, right? Why would Mickey, if they're going to even say there was a name change, why would he ever change his name to be different from his mentor and drop the E? I mean, that would be, dude, you
That's
know what
insane.
I'm saying? Yeah.
Just freaking insane.
Did you see the
mean,
article?
Weird shit's happening
you
in your town.
Did you see that Lowell Sun article? I mean, it literally said Mickey now without the E in fucking parentheses as I'm reading it. It didn't say that today, dude. It didn't say that today.
That is just, yeah.
There's
I believe
no
that, man. It's so weird when the updates come. It's like, it slaps you right in the face.
I'm not going to screen grab a video that 1,000 people are going to see and not read the article first. That's not how I roll. I read that article. It didn't have that fucking thing in there about his name not having the E. That's insane. And if that's going to be the backstory, like I just said, and you brought up about Mickey O'Keefe, why would he drop the E and spell his name different than the guy he's already got the same name as? That's his mentor. That'd be like a slap in the face, if anything.
Oh, really? Really?
But hey, that's how these Mandela effects roll. They don't make no fucking sense.
Nah, these Mandelas are just, you know, they're just out there. They're so far out, it's not funny. You know, some of them are scary. You know, there's like, you have hundreds and hundreds of people knowing something, and then everybody else is like, nah, you're freaking crazy. It's just bizarre. Anyway, well, that's all I got to say for tonight. I'll hang up and let somebody else call in and chew on your ear for a while.
All right, thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. You're welcome. I really appreciate everything you do. You're wonderful.
And I appreciate all you guys following me around and jumping through all the hoops because, you know, that's my biggest concern is I'm going to lose so many people when they shut me down. But you guys usually come out strong with the numbers on the backup. I appreciate that.
Yeah. They didn't send me a notification. I got it through, I jumped on from that little 22-second video you put it in
really?
Earlier at 7:30.
Yeah, I seen Karen say that in the chat too, and somebody else. What the fuck? I got the notification this time, even the 30-minute one. That's weird. That's how it goes.
Wow.
That's why you know they're gonna make me with their censorship be forced to have different channels. Well, I'm gonna make quick videos on my other channels to definitely get a notification out about the upcoming video. You know.
Sure. Yeah, because I would have probably checked you later on anyway, just to see if you were doing something. But you know, because I know I don't get all the notifications.
Yeah.
So, anyway, well, you have a good night, and it's a great vid so far.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye. All right, somebody else call in, 978-435-0006. And while I'm waiting, I'm going to go into a screen share. I want to show you guys something. And you can call right in anytime. I'll answer the phone right away. I'm just going to show some images while we wait of this mispronunciation, as people might want to say. And some of these I might click through because there are a couple here that didn't have residue. Here's Centerville Social Club residue right here. Venue. There's a lot of these places that have it. Any realtor has tons of it, and we called a realtor. Steffi did. Awesome call. Look at the Centerville neighborhood. Why is it in print if it's a fucking pronunciation issue? Dude, they're selling houses, three-bedroom houses. This isn't just an, you know what I mean? Look at this, Centerville. Okay? And this goes on and on. I mean, we'll go through a couple while we're here. You knew you grew up in Lowell when your neighborhood, Acre, Centerville. Homeboy's map, though, says Centralville on it. Top right corner. Centralville. Back here, too. Look, Centerville. Centerville, baby. We've gone through this. I'm just waiting for somebody to call. I'll just scroll through these until somebody calls. You know what I mean? Call in 978-435-0006. Centerville photos from the Lowell Sun. And there's articles, Lowell Sun, everything. Centerville. It goes on and on. It's no surprise. Centerville Booster Club. Centerville, Lowell High. This is me, 2013, Centerville. Anyone heading to Centerville? This is people I live with. People that say, you know, they would say the Mandela effect isn't real. They bought this house, sold the last house. Right on the Centerville Draget line. Dan Riley, Centerville mofos. This is me again, Centerville. My friend Samantha, Centerville. I'll be in the Centerville area. Nobody even heard of Centerville. Is that kid's hat? Centralville, as he writes at Centerville, because his hat changed. Here's my friend's mom. Here's the Centerville Sportsman's Club post. And this actually was a taggable post. Centerville Sportsman's Club. Look it up, guys. It's the Centralville Sportsman's Club. And that's in the next town. Oh, Drake it. Changed. Lowell Sun. Power failure blacked out. 10,000 homes in Lowell's Centerville section. Is this a pronunciation thing? It's in the Lowell Sun. Is that a pronunciation? Lowell, in the Lowell Sun again, selling properties. Centerville. Pronunciation? Centerville. Pronunciation? We don't know how to talk around here? Fuck are you talking about? Way to move this. Located in the Centerville section. That's enough of that. I've done this enough times. I don't need to prove that anymore to anybody. It's fucking people, man. I'm not crazy. I know that much. I'll tell you that. I am certainly not crazy. Yep. So who wants to call in? 978-435-0006. Somebody call in. Who's calling in? Carla, you on the horn? Calling in or what? Who's calling in? 978-435-0006. Somebody call in. I'm going to take a break and go smoke. Anybody calling in? All right. I guess we'll go to break. Hold on. Let me get my music up. All right, you listen to Dose of Reality. I'll be back in 5 minutes. You guys wanted to slack on the phones.
Did you know your reality is being put to the test? The Panama Canal no longer runs east and west. Things you are sure happened never did in this reality. The crunchy cereal with the captain now has an apostrophe. Summer changed for many folks. Shit, that punctuation now just showed up on different strokes. This shit can't be attributed to only digital content. Take a look at South America. They moved the whole fucking continent. Even pop in your copy of Star Wars. It could be 30 years old. Shit went as C-3PO, not all fucking gold. Maybe you haven't noticed the changes yet. Open your eyes, trust your senses, and you realize the Mandela effect. I'm from the reality where the youngest Jackson was a girl. Volkswagen logo had no line and Ford had no curl. The Black Tom attack we didn't learn of in school. It was always "Who Will Save Your Soul" sung by Jewel. The music ones really stand out to me. It's no longer "I Want to Paint It Black" in this reality. People writing it off as bad memory. Even with Superman, Chris Reeves running your trap, dismissing it is one of my pet peeves. Everything I research, people say it's a psyop. Even simple things like pointing out the towers can't collapse from the top. Somehow we are experiencing merging timelines. For more research, check out my site, The Real News Online. I started noticing changes in like 2014. It was JFK, the six-seater, that seemed so obscene. Many people will try and call me a loon. But hold up, wait, they even changed the spelling of Looney Tunes? Let these thoughts sink deep into ya. How could you ever miss the Great Wall of India? Statue of Liberty was on Ellis Island. Go search there for it now, and you won't find it. It's time for you to wake up. Hello, Clarice. In this reality, the Monopoly guy never had the eyepiece. Some of these changes, I don't see how you can dispute. For me, it was always the Smithsonian Institute. Institution? Well, to my ears, that's simply noise pollution. For me, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. The human anatomy changes bug me out, but really, they should. As contrived as they may be, it was always daylight savings time and Halley's Comet for me. Our poor neighbors up north are swallowed by the sea. Some of these geography changes are so obvious to me. You might think, Brian, you went too far. I'll say, since when is Cuba as big as Florida? Hey, listen up here. The forest fighting ranger was called Smokey the Bear. I'm writing this song to have a little fun. Raise your awareness. If I build it, I know they will come. So what's causing this, many want to know? Well, I don't think it's CERN, they're just a magic show. Satanists doing rituals while scamming mad dough. Sounds familiar, like liars that always show us the globe. NAS, NIST, CERN, and more. We really need to show these corrupt agencies the door. I don't think this phenomenon is caused by man. I think it's a great awakening, possibly God trying to contact us any way he can. For me, Flat Earth Mandela and our dreams are all connected. Looking to pull some people in that I can intersect with. Trying to wrap your head around it, it can be a hoot. Now Italy, it's no longer a standing boot. Shit, I'm hoping these changes might actually make me kinda cute. As crazy as this shit may seem to be, now Chewbacca has never been a Wookiee. It's time to look into this and get your dose of reality. Before you mock me and call me a fool, just remember, Lucy, you got some splaining to do.
ODDTV.
Your cell phone, your wallet, your time, your ideas. No barcode, no party, no ID, no beers. Your bank card, your license, your thoughts, your fears. No SIM card, no disco, no photo, not here. Your blood, your sweat, your passions, your regrets, your profits, your time off, your fashions, your sex, your pills, your dress, your tits, your ass. Your laugh, your balls, we want.
We want your soul.
Your house, your phone, your life, your cash. Your house, your phone,
we want your soul.
Your house, your phone, your life, your cash. Your house, your phone,
we want your soul.
Tell us your habits, your fats, your fears. Give us your address, your shoe size, your ears. Your digits, your plans, your number, your eyes, your schedule, your desktop, your details, your life. Show us your children, your photos, your home. Here, take credit, take insurance, take a loan. Get a job, get a pension, get a haircut, get a suit. Playing the lottery, play football, play the field, snore some toot. We'll show you dreams, we'll show you spook, we'll buy you dreams, throw away your book, we'll sell you crap, we'll charge you debt, we're gonna buy big guns, we'll
want
the cash.
Your soul,
your house, and your phone,
we you want your soul.
Your house, and your phone,
we you want your soul.
Your house, and your phone,
we you want your soul.
Your house, and your phone,
we you want your soul.
Your thoughts, your emotions, your love, your dreams, your checkbook, your essence, your sweat, your screams, your security, your sobriety, your innocence, your society, yourself, your place, your distance, your space.
All right, let's hope we get some calls. If not, I mean, I can just come back when Jen's ready in an hour and just do a second stream. But we'll see if anybody wants to call in. I'll open the phones back up. Give me 1 second. All right, phones are open. 978-435-0006. The number's right on the screen. You really can't miss it. All right, who's calling in? Who's calling in? Well, what we were talking about, the whole Centerville thing. Let me turn my AC on. Other people have noticed changes like this, too. Sandy has talked to some of the street in her town has changed. Another town near her. Blaze has talked about stuff over in his area in Japan. A lot of letters merging. Even a school that he worked at changed locations on him. Who's this? Dose of Reality. Who's this?
This is John from Iowa.
What's up, Johnny?
Well, fighting a good fight, as usual. I had an interesting Mandela little effect as I talk to a lot of people during the day. Mm-hmm. And I see a lot of the college kids and even a lot of the 40 and 50-year-olds wearing Star Wars shirts all the time.
Yeah.
So I'd like to ask some questions about it. And there was a guy, I don't know, mid-20s, and on his shirt was C-3PO and R2-D2, and C-3PO had a silver leg. So I asked him, I said, hey, what color is C-3PO? And he looked at me and he goes, gold. I'm like, oh, C-3PO is gold. Okay. Like, the whole thing? And he just looks at me like, yeah. And I'm like, well, look at your shirt. And he looks down at his shirt. And he just shakes his head, and he's like, "Well, I guess except for his leg." I'm like, "But you just said that he was gold."
Yeah.
He goes, "Yeah, I know, but he has one leg that's silver. It blows me away. Like they know the truth, or well,
yeah.
Okay, some people know." But then they instantly dismiss it. And he was even wearing the dang shirt. It was insane, dude.
It's really insane because that's when I get it. Like, I get it how some people, they just don't see it. And they always remember it the way it is now and always has been allegedly, right? But more often than not, I mean, I get almost everybody with a bunch of them. And they'll answer things the way I remember. But then when you try and tell them, they just take that update, dude. You know, I tried to have this conversation yesterday. There was four of us doing a roundtable. I don't know if you've seen it, but I'm like, what? Well, we need to talk about, like, it'd be a whole show, like, just some theories on, like, what is the source of that update, right?
Oh, yeah, that's a very good question.
Because it's very real.
I don't...
Update might not be the best term for it, but go ahead.
No, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
I don't think we're going to get any real answers until... we actually get the ruling class, if you want to call them that, over us,
mm-hmm.
like out of power, out of control.
Yeah.
I mean, I know you're mostly, well, this show right now is Mandela Effect, but
sure.
Like one of the biggest events that I can think of is this stupid, well, I know you probably don't even want to talk about it, but the damn Epstein thing. That thing really gets to me. Holy smokes.
Yeah. I mean, I don't honestly, it doesn't bother me that you want to talk about it. It's just, I don't really have anything to give to it because just the place where I'm at, I just completely unplugged from those stories and I just totally ignored it when people talked about it. And I just knew what was kind of the stories that were going to come out after. Obviously, they're going to find him dead in the cell. I mean, could anybody not see that coming? I mean, so is it even a real story? I don't know. I don't let get my emotions going. Why do you let that bother you so much? It's just, I don't know, man.
Well, to me, it's like the 9/11. Mm-hmm. At this point, people have been confronted with something that is obviously manufactured. Everybody called it, even on the quote unquote mainstream media and stuff. I mean, everywhere people called it. Oh, there's no way he's going to live the trial. There's no way he's going to live the trial. Well, guess what? He didn't live the trial. And yet people aren't going to take that to where it actually should go, which then should be like, hey, what the hell's going on? You know, obviously there's a serious problem with our government. But when every single major person to testify ends up dead.
They just accept it, and though. They accept all of it.
Yeah, that's hard, man.
Yeah, they just accept it.
And now
it on
I
its
see
face.
Him spinning it, and it's just, it's annoying.
Yeah.
I was hoping it was going to be a wake-up, Brian. That's why it annoys me. And it doesn't annoy me personally, because like you and so many other people, I knew it was going to happen. Of course it was going to happen. However, people's reaction to it is terrifying. That
Bro.
The obvious corruption that exists in our system is there for everyone to see, and the whole world sees it. And on foreign message boards, which I tend to try to go to, we're a laughingstock worldwide at this point, because they're like, look, Americans got nothing to bitch about because their system's more corrupt than like most everyone else's, and they don't even care.
Yeah.
And it's like, I don't know, you know, I was hoping, you know, like a lot of people, that something more would come of it, and it just didn't. So it was kind of sad, I'm just saying. I realize this is a personal journey and all that kind of stuff, but I'm still wanting to look out for my fellow man. But my fellow man seems to be asleep at the wheel, man, just like, wow.
Well, they are asleep at the wheel, and that's why I say there's got to be a line in the sand. For me, it's the moon landing, or it's the event with Mr. Robbie P. down in Connecticut. If people can't see through those, there's really nowhere to go with them. I mean, if the moon landing, or at least 9/11 as well, but 9/11, I mean, everybody sees that, and that's at least something it's not supposed to be. I mean, if people believe the official, I mean, don't even bother with them. But if people can't get past the Apollo moon landing being a hoax, well, they can't get past, you know, Robbie P and his whole laughing on camera and all that shit. Where do you go from there? We're going to have to leave those people behind, bro. I used to feel bad saying that. We're going to take everybody, or everybody's going to get to wherever we're going type of thing. But, dude, those people are not ready, man. They're just not ready. We can't let them fucking bog us down. They're not ready. And when I understand everybody is ignorant to things until they look, and you know, not everybody's going to look at the moon landing, even from 2019. But when you present it to people, and they'll see a wire harness, or you'll show them some ISS stuff, and they see a green screen, or you show them a fake plane on 9/11, but they still just go back into it and just accept it, then fuck them, bro. Because, like, if they don't care about being lied to, why are we going to waste our energy on them, you know? So I'm not saying fuck everybody, because I'm out here trying to wake everybody up, but when it gets down to the nitty gritty, it's like the people that are just going to accept the lies, we can't change that in them. That's just who they are. They're going to have to go on their own journey to a point where they're not going to accept lies anymore, and then maybe they'll get directed out of here. That's my opinion.
I understand that. However, you know, not to gloom and doom the show up.
That's cool. Go ahead.
When I read those FBI documents that they've got that showed that they wanted to make anyone who believes in conspiracy theories a domestic terrorist.
Okay.
And they also included false flags.
But you do
in
know
that particular
you do
list.
You do know that,
and that
they recycled this and they did the same shit 9 years ago, right?
Right.
But
however,
it's all domestic terrorists and all this, and it's still
not,
the
not,
same.
Not what? Not a week later, a week 10 days later, after this came to light. Then this stupid thing happened with Epstein. So now anybody who doesn't believe the official story is a domestic terrorist. And see, the reason why I'm still talking about it is because right now there's, you know, there used to be, you know, what, 3, 5, 10 million of us like running around complaining about this. But now there's 100 million people. I mean, there's an opportunity here. There's far more people who understand that this was fake. And now all of them should understand that they are now domestic terrorists for not believing the government and where that goes. I mean, we got serious issues. They're going to come after the people who do know, so that eventually the only people that will be left are the people who don't have a clue and don't care.
See, I think what they're going to do is...
they forgot about it.
No, what I think they're going to do is what they did the last time with the label. It's just another label to make all the other people look at us in a negative light, which sucks. You know, they're going to think we're domestic terrorists or whatever. But they're not going to actually round any of us up or arrest us or anything like that. They're not going to do that. It's not what they want to do. They don't want to draw that attention to us. And once you start hitting the streets with military or you start rounding people up and it's blatantly unjust, like on a big level like that, that's when people, almost all the people will wake up. Once you take the arms to the citizens, then fucking people who won't look into 9/11 or Apollo are going to be like, oh, hell fucking no. Maybe not everybody. A lot of people will submit, but a hell of a lot more people will rise up. That's why they don't want to do that. In my opinion.
Well,
I could be wrong.
Now, if we're going to combine everything together, now we have to deal with the fact that there might be these red flag laws on a federal level instead of just on a few states. And since they declare anyone who doesn't believe the government as mentally ill in the actual psychology profession, they, you know, if you are against the government, then you have a mental disorder. And so with the red flag laws, they can come and already have come, and people have already been shot. This is not like something that could happen. This is something that is happening, that where they come to the house because, you know, some relative said, well, he believes in, you know, conspiracy theories. And conspiracy theories include Mandela effect and everything else.
Well, let me ask you this, though. When those stories have come out, right? How come it's never been one single prominent truther that we know that's putting a message out to a lot of people, and it's just somebody that could be a no-name that they just put out there in the media to put the fear in your eyes to make you not want to talk out, the same reason why they would fake killing JFK?
Well, I'm with you there. I'm just saying that it seems like they're putting a lot of dots together to form a picture. And since they're doing more and more false flags, and since we're pissing in their Wheaties by, like, exposing their constant false flags, even with their demonetization, even with their censorship, they haven't been able to shut us all down.
I'm not saying we're not being targeted and monitored hardcore. I mean, we are definitely being targeted, bad-mouthed and all that. I just don't think it's going to come down to them rounding us up or charging us with a crime for what we're saying type of thing. I just don't think that's what they want to do. Because they're much smarter than that, and they can move 10 steps ahead of that and not do that.
Well, I certainly hope you're right, and I would prefer it to go that way.
Right.
However, it's just really annoying that the series of events and all the different dots on our end, that I'm going to keep going, of course. I'm going to keep going until the bitter end. So that's not an issue for me. It's just sad that we haven't been able to find an effective means to wake enough people up. If Epstein can't wake people up, and 9/11 can't wake people up, the moon landing can't wake people up, the Mandela changes can't wake people up. I mean, what the hell are we going to do to get these people to pull their heads out, man?
The numbers are gonna be a lot less than we ever thought, man. That's why I always told people to talk about, when's everybody gonna realize flat Earth and this and that? And I'm like, dude, you're not even gonna get to 50%. I mean, let's not kid ourselves. If we got to 25-30% of the Earth, I mean, that's a fucking victory, bro, because that'll make enough noise and uproot everything. You know what I'm saying? We're not gonna wake fucking 40-50% of people up to this stuff. It's just not gonna happen. But every time we wake up more, I feel really good about it. And you know, people always say, like, hey, why do you do it? Or what's the next step? I don't fucking know what the next step is. It probably hasn't been revealed to any of us yet what the next step is. But why do I do it? Well, the same reason I've always done it is because, shit, if there's truth to speak, we need to speak it. I need to talk to you guys just like you need to talk to me. And we have to stop silencing ourselves. And I said that to Nora when we were sitting in the diner. And I'm like, yeah, look at this fucking lady. He's dropping on us talking about Boston bombing and all this shit, right? And I'm like, but you know what? Let's just talk. Because we're speaking truth. These people talk about all this bullshit, shit in the Matrix. So much of it is lies, and they know a lot of it's lies. I mean, they'll just talk gossip, Hollywood sites, all types of bullshit they'll talk around. You just talk shit about people. We are going to speak truth about valuable fucking information and about these phenomenal times we're going through, and why do we have to shut up about it? You know what I'm saying? We all do it. I'm not saying I don't do it. I fucking shut up all the time in certain places, you know? But when we're just having a conversation with somebody else that understands, if people want to listen or don't want to listen, fuck them. I mean, we're talking about things that are actually important. They're talking about fucking nothing. I mean, not all the time. Let's say everybody else talks about nothing important. But most of the time, they're talking about fucking absolute nothing. And it's not even their fault. It's because it's stuff that's put in front of them that they think is actually something. But it's fluff. It's fucking garbage for your brain.
Oh, I agree. I mean, it is. Since I live in a college town, I deal with a lot of college kids. So I get the unique opportunity to, like, ask them questions about what they're studying and this kind of stuff. And it is insane that we're letting the universities go on turning all these kids into fucking, not mindless robots. Don't think they're mindless. No, they are very angry, hateful, anti-religious zealots. Like, zealots. I currently live with a guy who is a astrophysicist. He's got his master's and he's going for his PhD. And he is 100% convinced that there's no spirituality of any kind whatsoever in the whole world, and that science is the only answer. And I tried to, like, just hint that maybe science is like a different form of religion. And he shut down so fast. He's like, no. Science is just the truth. Science is the truth. And I'm like, well, how about who pays for the science? Don't you think who pays for the science might have some bearing on the results? No. Science is pure. Well, isn't it true that they absolutely don't show all the results, or if they find results that are troubling, that they'll just sideline them? No. It's all true. It's difficult to even broach any question, because they have the answers. Oh yes, they have the answers.
Yep, it's crazy. And Truth Seeker just joined us. Jen, I muted your mic because I was getting feedback. I'll unmute you, but hang on. Let me see. How. I think we're okay now. Anything you want to say to the caller, or call you? I'm gonna let Jen in. Okay. Thank you for the call, brother.
No problem. Hi, Jen.
Hi. How you doing?
John from Iowa.
John, you have anything you want to ask Jen while you got her on? While we got you on.
Well, Jen, have you had any luck waking any new people up to the Mandela effect in real life, like on the streets as opposed to the internet?
Yeah. I deal with the public every day, so I always have an opportunity to plant some seeds. Just the other day, I talked to a couple of women about Eli Whitney again. You know, I just ask them, black or white, Eli Whitney, what do you remember? And they were pretty blown away to find out that he's white now. So I pick my targets, you know. I already kind of have a few things lined up. I look for certain people, I target them, I guess you might say, and I just go for it. And, you know, either it piques their curiosity and they run with it, or they don't. But usually, lately, it's been piquing a lot of people's curiosity. I'm getting more feedback, positive feedback and curiosity, rather than who cares? What does this even matter? Like, I don't even care. I don't understand it. I don't even want to try to understand it. I don't even care. I used to get that a lot. What difference does it make? Who cares? You know what I mean? But when you target certain people with things that are either cultural to their background, or a distinct memory in history that they may have lived through.
And there's too many. It's easy to do. It's easy to make it resonate with people because you can get them with every category. And that's what
I mean, if you just start hitting them with JCPenney and Bragg's and stuff, they're going to be like, who cares? I mean, really, in the scheme of things, that is kind of small and insignificant, although I'm sure it has its purpose somewhere along the line. But if you really want to try to wake somebody up and help somebody who has no clue to just suddenly be like, holy crap, what is this? Because, you know, people rely on their memories. Even though the Alzheimer's is running rampant right now, and it's one of the leading killers amongst elderly people right now. And I believe that was put on us by design because they don't want us remembering. And, you know, of course, that's all by design. We all know that already. But people trust their memories. They know what they've seen. They know what they've studied. They know what they lived through. You know, if I see somebody with a NASA shirt on, I'm going to go right over and be like, hey, the only thing NASA ever sent into space was your imagination.
I see those more now than ever. And it's not just because I'm into flat earth and stuff, because I've been into it for 5 years, but I'm in the last like 8-9 months, the NASA t-shirts, I mean, they're pumping them out. Just like they're pumping out more and more NASA stories to try and
find them. Like an army of NASA shirts.
They're probably giving them away for free.
Probably. They probably sent them out in the mail. And next thing you know, and one lady told me that she got hers out of one of those clothes bins where you donate clothes. You go to that, like, you know, like they're in parking lots and stuff. She said she got hers out of one of those. I said, well, that's actually where it belongs. You know,
last year when I don't know if you even knew my channel at the time. And I was on a band at that time. I was doing shows, just got put onto the Real News Online. So my first show I was going to do, and my family asked me to on the backup, and my family asked me to come out to a baseball game. And I don't usually go out much, you know, local baseball game at the Spinners Park. Lumpy, if you're listening, you know the Spinners Park. So I said, yeah, I'll go to the game. We go to the game. And they knew this. It was fucking NASA night at the park. There was an astronaut there, and they were giving away astronaut bobbleheads, dude. And they tried to tell me about it. And it's like, you know, it gets real aggravating because it's like, you guys are fucking unbelievable, the shit you're saying to me. And it's like, but then when the thing is, when people want to bring up that conversation to me, like at work, they'll bring up stuff and take shots at Flat Earth or whatever. And I'll start to explain something. Oh, I don't really care. Well, then don't bring it up. You got embarrassed is what it is. You realize you don't know a fucking thing about what you're talking about.
Yeah. I don't understand how people could not care. Only because...
John, I'm going to let you go, okay? Thank you for the call, brother.
Thank you, absolutely. Thanks for the call. Have a great night.
Yep. You too.
I'm going to shut the phones for a few minutes, Jen. Go ahead.
All right. The thing about the astronaut at the baseball game, I feel like that's like a patriotic attachment that they're kind trying to reconnect with people, because so many people are waking up to the flat earth that they have to do this kind of shit. They got to send astronaut out to baseball games and give out bobbleheads to try to get that patriotic emotional attachment back for people to believe in it again or to keep their belief going, because it's falling apart and there's more people waking up to that. To that whole fraud every day, and thank goodness for that. But as far as Mandela effect stuff, I just like I said, I try to focus on the important things that would be important to the people that I come across. Now, if I knew somebody used Braggs all their lives, I would use that as an example.
So
I heard you on that show a couple days back. I think it was Karen B maybe or somebody in that Zulu, I don't know how to say his name, Zulu or
yeah.
And she was kind of like lackadaisy about it, like, oh, well, you know, I don't care, who cares, what you know what I mean? And I don't get that. It annoys the crap out of me when I hear people like, yes, you know, I mean, this is monumental what's happening. Maybe we're not meant to figure this thing out. Maybe we're just meant to observe it and see it and to see the signs. This is a clear sign that something is happening, something huge is happening. And even though they might not care now, they will. That's all I have to say to the people. Well, I don't care. Well, you will care. You'll care very soon. And don't be putting stuff up on that screen that I can't see.
No, I put up Karen's message because she's here.
Okay.
But no, a good way we can relate that to her and other people is like, that's just like when people tell you, well, the flat earth doesn't matter. What do I care? And it's because they haven't looked yet and they haven't experienced it. Then once you start to look and see how deep it is, then you'll realize, oh, wow, this really is important. You know, when things are supernaturally changing, history's changing. I got a lot of those people. Zulu, Karen, other people on there with the Bible ones, and I'm not an expert in the Bible.
Oh, I heard you.
The trespasses changed the debtors. Definitely got you with that one.
And the whole thing with Jesus being hung on a tree. Okay, first off, he was crucified. Crucified means they nail you to the cross, okay? And during the Stations of the Cross in Catholic school, when it's that time of the year when they're reliving the Station of the Cross, every time he dropped the cross, they would make this huge bang in the church that would like echo. And it would be like, you know, because three times he fell or he dropped the cross. And each time they would make this really loud bang noise. So it like shook you. And I mean, when you're hung on a cross, you're not, I mean, if you're hung on a tree, it's different than being nailed to a cross. You're not saying they nailed them to a tree. They just hung them up there. You know what I mean? I mean, like, what is that?
Let's talk about metaphor mode. I love talking about metaphor mode. So I bring up the Bible changes to these, you know, hardcore religious people. And they do one or two things. They'll just deny it. You know, the word of God can't change. They're blue in the face. But if you get them to look after saying that and telling you that it's not in there and the word of God can't change. So if I brought up Act 5:30 and they went and seen that Jesus was indeed hung in a tree now, they would come back with, well, a cross is made from wood and wood comes from a tree.
Yeah.
So there you have it. And that's, they've said this to me.
Yeah, that's just rationalizing it, but you know, that's bullshit. Every person who's ever gone to Catholic school knows that Jesus was nailed to the cross. They laid that shit down. They nailed his feet. They nailed his hands. They even show where they nailed his hands in there and everything. And now what? Now he's like, what's he carrying on his back all the way up to be crucified or hung? Is he dragging the tree up the hill here that they're going to hang him on? I don't even get it. I just... But it's ink, it's paper, it's man-made stuff. And the Bible is made by man. It's supposed to be inspired by God through these people who wrote it. But do we really even know that? I mean, we're just going by what they've told us.
I'll say, reckon, like it is, like I've always said it, I don't care who it pisses off. You know that all the information we get, especially through mainstream sources, has been completely manipulated and meant to dumb us down and brainwash us and not give us the real information. Now, knowing that and knowing how it's not the new world order, it's always been the old world order. It's always been here. It's the same people. Sure, people die and move on, but it's the same people generally controlling that information and controlling the real money since the beginning of time. Do you think that if there is a book claimed to be the word of God, that's not going to be the first thing that they're going to try to manipulate you with? Like, what the fuck are you thinking, man?
Yeah, exactly. As a matter of fact, a lot of the things in there are meant to control you. Now, if they can keep the masses following these rules and doing what they're supposed to do and being good little Christians and stuff, then they can go over here and do what they want. Well, you know, this book will keep people in line. You know, this book will allow people to gatekeep each other and stuff like that. Now, I'm not saying there isn't good stuff in the Bible. I'm not saying, you know, it doesn't have some pretty good, there's some good stuff in there. I don't know who put it there, but there is some good stuff. But there's also a lot of stuff that has been Mandela affected. And, you know, it's a supernatural thing for sure. Obviously, something is changing things on a molecular level in our own homes, in real time, retroactively. And since it's a spiritual battle and it's about good and evil and, where we wind up in this battle, because we're kind of like in the middle of it all. Because you said numerous times you don't think it's Lucifer or Satan doing it or his minions or whatever. But on that spiritual level, that's how I see it, is that, you know, things are happening. And yes, we're meant to see it and recognize that this is the time that we're in. These are the signs that we're seeing. And this is the shit that's going down now. And it's going to lead to somewhere else. And you need to be awake on a level that you can see this stuff and understand it and not be paranoid. That caller who was saying, oh, are you paranoid? Don't you get paranoid? I don't get paranoid. This is not about paranoia. This is about observing and seeing.
I'm trying to calm him down because, listen, I've been doing this a long time. You know how many times I heard that we're being labeled domestic terrorists? I mean, they just do it every couple years.
I've been a domestic terrorist for like 10 years now.
Dude, I'm a fucking domestic terrorist, liquid terminator, sim shill, tranny truther. What's up? I got a penis and a vagina. I'm having a good time.
Oh, you're special.
I'm going to go fuck myself.
You got the best of both worlds.
I'm going to go fuck myself. Yeah, this video is getting straight.
You're like a bowling ball.
I'm getting hung like Mr. Ed. Okay, next.
Don't get me started. Just want to put this out there. I made it to 10,130 subscribers. And then I put up a re-upload of my Flat Earth song. What is it? The Earth is Flat. The Globe is an Illusion. I reposted.
You,
You did a song?
No, no. I had re-uploaded the song that I put all the animations to this song, and I re-uploaded it from my channel because I already had it on there. And as soon as I did that, I went from 10,130 subscribers to 10,006, like that. I was like, okay, yeah, no problem. I got all these thumbs up, all these views, all these great comments, but yet I lost, like, you know, 125 subscribers. So, yeah, YouTube's doing their due diligence to fuck with everybody and their subscribers and view counts and thumbs up and all that bullshit. I mean, it's not important, but for me, I feel like I'm reaching people. And when I see my subscribers go up, you know, I do get excited because more people are coming to my channel. That means more people are waking up because I'm talking about stuff that's pertinent information. It's not just bullshit, you know, like rainbows and cotton candy and stuff all day long. What was that you just had up there? You're too quick for me, Brian.
That was funny after the last one. You're like, I watched that video back with my mother. I seen all the shit you had up on the screen.
I was like, I'm so into reading the Secret Covenant, and he's like, writing all this shit. Cracking up laughing over there. I was like, duh.
What is that weird picture behind you?
Weird picture behind me?
Yeah.
It's a collage of pictures. It's got my son's. My husband's son's in that picture. My two boys are in it. Well, my two young men, I should say. My oldest is turning 30 October 31st. Excuse me, October 21st. He'll be 30 years old. And you got me again. See, I'm going to. Why do I start live streaming? And I have you on my show. Wait, you just wait, Brian. I got something for you. It's got your name on it. Yeah, you're going to be like this. Oh my god. I'll Who wants to see me tase Brazer? Tase Brian right now.
Oh boy.
Yeah, oh boy. Anyway, I'm about to make a new video here. It's going to take me a little time. A lot of research is going into it, but it would seem not only are the airplanes Mandela affected, but the whole aeronautic industry history has been Mandela affected.
Well, it's crazy. There's some people here that don't know probably even about the simplest, not the simplest, but the real obvious, the jet engine one. There's people here that don't know. I know there are because I have people here from the Flat Earth side that haven't looked at Mandela that much. Let me bring it up real quick just to show people because this is crazy. And, you know, this is nothing new to Mandela people. But again, you know why I do what I do. So here we go. So hang on. Now, check this out. Airliners in my reality, right? Let me show you where is the jets. Hold on. I have a folder. Here it is. Okay. So, in my reality, where I came from originally, or whatever I remember, this is how an airliner looks. Now, this looks, you would be like, yeah, that's exactly how an airliner looks, right? And I'll show you guys. This is what I remember. Now, this is a video game, because, and I'm going to tell you why, a real airliner is not going to look like that, because they've changed. They've been Mandela affected. Now notice, this looks like a regular commercial airliner. You notice the jet engine under the wing. This is what I remember. Now, there's more shots of it, right? Now, if you go and look at where the engines are now on a commercial airliner, wait till you see this. That's not commercial, but that's where they are. Look at the engines. This is a commercial airliner. Now, this is all commercial airliners, except for one Boeing model that hasn't changed for some reason. It was some Boeing 737 model. I heard Blaze talking about it in his video. But look at these engines, guys. Guys, this is the nonsensical Mandela effect engineering. And I mean, listen when I tell you. You're going to say, well, yeah, they changed the design. Then show me a picture from 10 years ago. Show me a picture from 15 years ago of you standing on a runway in front of a jet. The engines are going to look like this. As ridiculous as that sounds. Go back and look at any photos you have of jets. They're going to have the engines like this. It doesn't even look mechanically sound. Look at this, Jen. I mean, yeah. I know you know, but look at this.
Yeah, anybody who flies frequently and, you know, ever sits at the wing and looks out the window would know that these things have moved if they have half a brain cell to rub together. I mean, you can't miss it.
This is in front. This is the front. This is looking out the right window of the plane.
Yeah.
This is in front of the wing.
And the wings are like floppy now. Like when you're hitting turbulence, you can really see them like going up and down like that on the plane. It's really crazy looking. And the plane itself makes all kinds of strange noises now. I mean, I've been on American Airlines, I've been US Airlines, Delta, I've been on Southwest, I've been on Spirit Airlines, you name it, I've been on it because I fly a lot. I've, over the last 20 years, I've flown probably more than 100 times. And the ride itself is completely different. When you feel the plane slowing down, it almost feels like you're stopping, like in air. It's bizarre feeling. It's very strange. And there's lots of noises that the plane makes now that I don't ever remember. I mean, I even caught it on video a while back. Last year when I went up from my mom's knee replacement surgery, I was filming out the window. And I'm like, yeah, these sounds I'm hearing aren't making me feel very confident. I don't know what's going on, but these noises are just not sounding right to me. And the guy next to me is like, I don't know what just happened. But it was like,
this is a unanimous one. I mean, look at everybody in the chat. Everybody remembers them under the wings. I mean, it's not, it's so ridiculous now. Like how some of these Mandelas are so wrong. Like, dude, the fucking engines don't even look like they could be supported there. The engines are supposed to be the heaviest part. And you got them fucking extended out in front of the wing. Like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah. So, you know, I did a video about Operation Question Mark with the airplane that did the refueling for 120 hours. It stayed up in the air. I don't know how they switched pilots. I don't know.
Tell people the date. Tell people the date.
Yeah, it's well, I have to go back to it here. It's on here. Go back to one of my other pictures. But it's like 1929. Okay, here it is. Yeah, 1929. Did you just put something up there again? I'm going to kick your ass, Brian.
I didn't. No.
You better not. They'll tell me in the chat.
No, they won't. I'll fucking ban them. Go ahead.
All right. Question mark was modified Atlantic Fokker C-2A transport airplane of the United States Army Air Corps in 1929. Commanded by Major Carl A. Is that feedback? I thought I heard feedback. Okay, anyway, it was flown for a flight endurance record as part of an experiment with aerial refueling. 1929. Question mark established new world records in aviation for sustaining flight. Heavier than air, refueled flight, sustained flight, lighter than air, and distance between January 1st and January 7th of 1929 in a nonstop flight of more than 150 hours near Los Angeles, California. You can look this up for yourself, guys. It's Operation Question Mark. You need to type the whole word out, question mark, and you'll get this up. So that's aerial refueling, 1929, 120 hours this plane stayed in the air. I don't know who was flying it. I don't know if they switched pilots at some point. I don't know where this person was using the bathroom at. I don't know what, but this is bizarre. It doesn't even make sense. Now, when do you guys remember drones coming into the picture? What date do you think drones came into the picture? Take a guess. Anybody? Drone, unmanned aircraft, radio controlled.
Take a guess, people. Just take a wild guess in the chat. You know how it goes with this tech before it's time shit with the Mandela effect, so.
Yeah.
When I saw that the fucking remote control for the TV, the wireless, was in 1955, that one floored me.
Okay, so Timothy says 1960. John says mid-80s. Dennis says 70s. Casey says 15 years. I guess he means 15 years ago. Okay, so after World War One. Okay, hold on. Let me start from the beginning. Winston Churchill and others wait to watch the launch of a de Havilland Queen Bee target drone. June 6, 1941. After World War One, three standard E-1s were converted to drones. The Larnex was an early cruise missile in the form of a small monoplane craft that could be launched from a warship and flown under autopilot. It was tested between 1927 and 1929. Okay, people, in 1903 was the first flight by the Wright brothers. in 1929, they're refueling 150 hours in the air and have autopilot? I don't think so.
That's
okay, come on. Okay, so in 1929 by the Royal Navy, the early success of the pilotless aircraft led to the development of radio-controlled pilotless target aircraft in Britain and the United States in 1930s. In 1931, the British developed the Fairy Queen radio-controlled target from the Fairy 3F float plane, building a small batch of three. And in 1935, followed up with the experiment by producing large numbers of another RC radio-controlled target, the DH-82B Queen Bee, derived from the Havilland Tiger Moth biplane trainer. The name Queen Bee is said to have led to the use of the term drone for pilotless aircraft, particularly when they are radio controlled. That's 1935. How do you like that map? Yeah. I got more. It keeps going. Okay. Later in November 1917, the automatic airplane was flown for representatives of the U.S. Army. This led to the Army to commission a project to build an aerial torpedo, resulting in the Ketting Bug, which was first flown in 1918. While the Bug's revolutionary technology was successful, it was not in time to fly in the war, World War I, which ended before it could be fully developed and deployed. And then down here it says that, you know, 1941, they were waiting to watch it take off or whatever. But they had already tested and flown this thing in 1918. Get the fuck out of here. And you can pull that up. I don't know. You got it all in your messages. If you're able to pull any of that up, I got it all. All the screenshots for you. You can just float them on there whenever you want.
Yeah, I'll do it in a bit. Hold on. I'm going to open the phone.
I'm telling you, this whole thing with the first flight with the Wright brothers, 1903. And then, you know, like 26 years later, they have aerial refueling with these two prop planes.
All gone back. Well, the stuff with all the technology stuff's crazy. Dude, now we know the color TV goes back to 1930. The fucking first Major League Baseball game in color is now in 1948. Dude, no way. That was in the mid to late 50s for me when they first had the first color Major League game. There was no way it was in 1948. There's just absolutely no way. I know it wasn't.
Yeah, this is all bizarre. The whole thing with airplanes and autonomous drones, pilotless aircraft, all this stuff is just all jacked up. It's all jacked up. It seems like everything's 20 years earlier than what we remember, 20 to 30 years earlier than what we would recall or remember or even assume would have taken place given the time frame that they have. There's no way in 26 years they could have done all this, okay? I mean, the Wright brothers barely got off the ground for 30 minutes, you know? They only went like 35 feet up in the air and just kind of like hovered around and bounced around and then went back down again. And now, you know, I mean, this is just insane. It's insane. Radio-controlled planes, seriously?
Well, I mean, and we don't even need to get into that. We can. I mean, look at all the war history that has changed. I mean, you know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like...
We did a whole show on it 2 weeks ago about Germany and the war and Black Tom, Torpedo Alley. Yeah. Come on, man.
I just happened to come upon this when I was looking up refueling one day. I mean, I didn't know it changed. Nobody pointed me towards it or anything. I was curious about something that I had seen in the sky. I saw two planes. One was a chemtrail plane, and the other one was the exact same plane. It was like, you know, not smaller or larger, but it was like just in front of the other one, and they were flying. And I'm looking up at this, seeing these two planes doubled up going across the sky, but one of them's leaving a trail. So the only thing I could think was that they had to be refueling because there was no way they would be that close and locked in the way they were moving across the sky. It was just the most bizarre thing that I had ever seen. And that's when I started looking up this refueling stuff. And I'm like, wait, what the hell is this? It didn't even make sense to me. It just seems like if we really go back and start taking a look at stuff, even like, say, you know, when these missiles were created or tanks.
Yeah, I've been watching a lot of these little so-called forgotten history type channels on YouTube.
and, you know, these little stories that supposedly everybody knew, but they don't know anymore type of thing, you know? And, like, I did you hear me talk about the fucking guy that invaded Britain? Did you hear me talk about that one?
Yeah.
Come on, exactly. Man.
Like, this one guy's going to go there and take on the whole Navy.
War, you're telling me the United States had a ship that fucking got to British soil in the Revolutionary War and made a commander seize their ship and all this shit? Dude, no, that never happened.
Yeah, that's like as big as like the Boston Tea Party. I mean, that would have been huge. We would have heard all about that. I never heard anything like that.
Oh, yeah, healthy living. Look what healthy living wrote. I want to talk about this one, too. This is a big one.
I used in 1984 middle school. Yeah. It was Macintosh.
Yeah, because the Macintosh Apple, anybody that doesn't know, everybody knows what a Macintosh Apple is. Look it up, guys.
The Macintosh it's MC now.
Never existed. It's MC. Macintosh. But the computer was named after the Apple. It's from the Apple fucking computer company. They named it a Macintosh after a Macintosh Apple. And those other things are still called Macs, not Mics. But it's a Macintosh Apple now. And always has been. If Apple doesn't blow your mind, take a look at bananas. Bananas grow upside down now. And I know this isn't new to people in the community, but as you know, we have a mixed crowd. Bananas grow upside down. It's crazy. Are you there, Jen? Did you die?
Yeah, I'm right here. Sorry, I had to grab some cigarettes. All right, so yeah, that's pretty bizarre. I'm going to do a whole video about it, but I'm going to put it together and, you know, really just lay it out because it's just not lining up at all. And then there's all that tech before its time stuff. That stuff is so fascinating. The one that really got me was the lady on the scooter. It looked like a scooter that you would use today, you know. You know, you go up to the scooter, scan your phone on it, and take off with these little scooters, and it looks exactly like that. You know, she's got her long, flowy black dress on and her big hat, and she's just scooting along on a dirt road, you know, because they had no road yet, but they had scooters. Crazy.
One of my favorite tech thing is, and I'll ask everybody in the chat, you know, and this isn't a new one, but when was the first video phone and video phone call? And when I say video phone, I'm talking about a monitor in front of you. It's obviously not a flat screen. Monitor in front of you, a little box behind it, with you on a corded phone, video-to-video conference call, like Skype with a corded telephone, video-to-video. What year do you guys think that came out? And I'll let everybody answer. What year would you think that came out?
I already know because I've done videos on this, but I would have thought it would have been like, say, like the 60s or something, but of course that's not true.
Aubrey says 95, 99. Well, it was in the 50s. It was in the 50s now. It was in the early 50s, video phones. Video phone calls, like basically a Skype call with a regular corded telephone in your hand. Looking at a screen, but just face-to-face with people in the 50s. Fucking insane.
Yeah, they had those fax machines you were talking about. A lot of weird stuff happened in the late 20s, 30s, and 40s that, you know, seemed like awesome technology. Actually, technology that we use today, but then somewhere along the line, it just kind of went under the rug and then came back out. You know, it's like, how is it that we went from video calls and all this other stuff, color TV back in the 30s or whatever, to, you know, when I was younger, I had a black and white TV. Why didn't I have a color TV if they were already out? You know what I mean? It just doesn't line up with anything that we remember. Everything's pushed back now. It's just so crazy.
Well, look at the resolution on all the old videos now. Look at the color. JFK, come on. We all, never mind, just before we even get into the four versus six and the 100 of other Mandela effects around it, and I have videos breaking it down for hours. There's so much. But come on, man, the Zapruder was in black and white. Now, in this reality, not only did Zapruder shoot the fucking movie with the with the color camcorder now, hand cam 1962, but there's 13 other fucking angles of the JFK assassination now.
Yeah.
There was not that. Come on, man. Everybody knows that's ridiculous.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I'm just baffled by this whole airplane thing. I used to go to the air shows with my grandpa when I was little up in Warminster, Pennsylvania. We'd see the Blue Angels. There was a big air base up there, Willow Grove Air Base. And we'd always go to the air shows. I always loved airplanes. I was always fascinated by them. I couldn't wait to go fly on one. And it wasn't until I was much older before I actually flew on a plane. And I actually want to have a pilot's license. If I can ever afford one, I plan on getting a pilot's license. So, you know, I've always been fascinated by this topic. And just to read this stuff lately, I'm just like, what the F is going on? This is not right. This is not right at all.
No, how do you guys not have seen this? There was only the Zapruder film.
I've never seen that.
One other real one. Dude, I got 13 videos right here of the JFK assassination. Look at all the color videos. So all these people had color hand cams in 1962. No big deal. Or 63, whatever it was. His was a 62 camera. I think the event was 63, right? So all these people in 1963 had these hand cams and many color ones. And they all filmed the assassination. But none of you people have ever heard of this. And again, when people say to me, well, Brian, this is things you don't hear about, this and that. Dude, but did you hear about this? Did you see these fucking 13 videos? No, you didn't. But they didn't just get released in some new JFK release or whatever. I mean, these videos have been on YouTube themselves for years. Look at this video published on YouTube fucking 13 fucking years ago.
Wow. You know, and these video cameras, what, back in the the early 90s, late 80s, where they were real big and bulky and you had to kind of have it on your shoulder and stuff. But, you know, and you didn't even really see many of those around. And these people all had these, no problem. Got their little real video cameras out.
here's another color one. Dude, and so many of them. This all just appeared in that timeline.
This is so foreign to me. This is so foreign. I've never seen this at all.
And this is, when I tell people, I'll tell things to people, I don't have that. You know, I'm telling them about Star Wars, the Bible. This is stuff people have, you know. Okay, well, what about the JFK? You never seen this, right? You never seen this event. Come on. I'm using big events here. Like, come on, dude. Come on. How did you not see all this footage? How do we all just have it now all of a sudden? How does the Zapruder film have fucking sound now? And how has it changed the backstory with the Dictabelt recording, where now in the 1960s and the late 60s, a commission on assassinations came to the determination that based on the audio that they got from that, the third shot was fired from the grassy knoll, and they came to the conclusion that there was a second shooter, and it wasn't until like 10 years later that they reversed their decision. I'm sorry, none of that is true where I came from, because where I came from, that was a conspiracy theory floated out, quote unquote, we'll call it, you know what I mean, whatever, we know what the word means, but that was a conspiracy theory floated out, but that was never anything that they admitted or came to a fucking conclusion on. And there was none of this video. Look at this video.
Yeah, none of this video was used in any of the documentaries or movies that were made about JFK. It was always just the Zapruder film. Always.
And again, guys, we monitor this stuff. So these videos weren't there. We on the, in this community, we all make JFK videos. Of course we do, right? Everybody has at least one. I have a few of them, right? I mean, I got like five fucking JFK videos. I do. I got a short one. Then I got one that's 2 hours long. Then when the audio came out, I did 2-3 hour one on that. Then I did another follow-up. Like, it's so it just keeps changing. It's one of the biggest events of all time, no matter what your views are on it. And it keeps changing. And we're watching it change in front of us, dude. Like, come on. Yeah. The audio wasn't there for fucking 3 years. 4 years, people have been talking about this Mandela effect. Nobody's ever heard the audio till like a month or two ago.
It was just there. The way that, you know, it actually changes his story, where, you know, we were all talking before about the driver possibly turning around and shooting JFK. Well, and now it's Jackie, supposedly. When I heard that, I almost like lost my shit. I was like, wait a minute, what? Now Jackie did it? It's like, oh my gosh. So she was some mind control victim of some sort or whatever, MK Ultra. And
the Mark Bell recording, the famous Mark Bell recording. Where have you been?
It's just fucked up. You know,
it just rolls off the tongue like the Zapruder film. You know, it's the Mark Bell film. What are you, a fucking dude? You live in a cave?
Mark Bell.
He's one of the guys that happened to film the JFK assassination in color.
They say that Jackie was like groomed by the Jesuits, and you know, she was all MK Ultra'd up and stuff, and the pink outfit she had on had some kind of symbolism behind it and stuff. I mean, I remember studying that thing, watching the driver, seeing if he turned and shot. You know, first off, you can't do that if there's two other people on the way and another windshield, supposedly, and all this stuff. I mean,
look at this one.
Yeah, that's crazy. But you don't really see the car like in the other ones.
No, you do. In all these, you do see the car at a certain point. This is all definitely, you see it. If you pay attention, you'll see it in all of them.
I guess because it's so small.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to really go back and look at these. Because I've never seen them. I've never seen them at all.
and I will provide everybody with the link real quick. Hang on, everybody. Here's the link, everybody. I have a playlist saved with all those videos. There you go. There's all the JFK videos. Put the link in the chat for everybody.
All right, cool. I'll have to check that out. I told you the other day I watched the movie Alien with my family.
Yeah.
Well, my mom really wanted to watch Aliens, the second one that was out after that, 1986. You know how I feel about space and everything. But yeah, it was just entertainment, purely entertainment. Okay, so we watch it, and my mom is sitting there. I don't remember this. Is this a director's cut? I don't remember none of this. It's like I'm watching a whole new movie.
And you were telling me that it had all the changes in it.
Well, the first one, I saw changes. My husband and I are like, what the fuck is this? Do you remember seeing this? I don't remember seeing this. And then we watch the second one, and my mom's sitting there, and I'm like, yeah, I don't remember this scene. This is weird. It had all these extra scenes in it that definitely made sense with the movie, gave you more information about the colonists that they were looking for and everything, and it was just like I was watching a whole new movie. It was like, I know it wasn't a director's cut. You can put it on any channel, any thing you have. Pull out your old Aliens movie from 1986 and watch it. It's got all new shit in it. It's crazy.
Yeah. And that's the thing, you know, like people say, oh, well, it's not a big deal. Dude, stuff that's in your possession is changing. I don't know how you can turn the other cheek to that. Like, and I know a lot of people say, well, I haven't seen that. Give me 5 minutes with you. Tell me what you have for movies. Tell me what you have for books. Let me know what some of your interests are. What music do you like? Like, I'll get you with stuff that you own. Trust me. You know what I mean? Like, it's easy. It's everywhere. Everywhere.
Yeah. You know, when it's in your possession and you saw it, you know, you've been looking at it, and then you look at it and it's like, it's changed. I don't know how that could not, you know, tip something off in your brain of curiosity to look further into this thing, or to even admit something is happening here. Reality is not what we thought it was. It can be changed. It's malleable. It's not as solid and permanent as we think it is.
Like, if people out here, like, I have a lot of friends here that know about, you know, the NASA deception and whatnot, right? Mm-hmm. And I often talk about these guys, how they agree on everything across the board. They'll push the global, you know, all the same shit, the global climate change, the dinosaurs, and they all think they're experts on everything, whether it's Bill Nye, Neil deGrasse, Brian Koch. They'll come out there and talk about all of these fucking things. Well, these people all try and say that we have no consciousness, we have no soul. And the Mandela effect is something for me that's very much proven that those things are very real. And honestly, I think that they're more real than this fucking construct that we're in. So for me, this is key, man. This is fucking key.
Yeah. I mean, they don't want you to know that you're conscious and you have a soul and a direct connection to the creator. So, of course, they're going to push the opposite. You know, you're an insignificant speck in space. We're all just some happenstance from a big bang that came out of nowhere, and nobody really knows how it all happened. And they're looking for the God particle.
But it's a joke. Yeah. And I don't get how people don't think that's important. Like, I get it. You don't want to be called a flat earther or whatever. That's fine. I don't want to be that. I don't want any label of any topic I look into anymore. I'm done with it, because all the fucking shit that comes along there, I'm done with it. But yeah.
Well, CERN is not looking for no Big Bang particle, because we know there was no Big Bang. So I don't know what the fuck CERN is doing and with all their money that's funneling into that thing. And we know NASA isn't sending anything up into space, so I don't know what the hell they're doing with all that money. But,
CERN is underground NASA for me. But the thing with the flat Earth stuff is, it's not, you can't let a group of assholes or a label that you don't like turn you away from something that might be a truth that you need to look at. Like, you can't do that. You have to look. And if people are lying to you on the level that NASA obviously is, once you look,
go on your own journey from there. Whatever you think the cause is, whatever it means to you, is it a financial thing because you don't like that they steal your money, you don't like that they steal your kids, you shouldn't like any of that, or is it a spiritual journey for you, whatever it is for you. But you can't just accept being lied to all the time and being manipulated. And the thing is, with the billions that they're stealing and with all the other industries involved and the media, Disney, and everything that's involved in this, not just NASA, obviously, right?
Yeah, they're all connected.
Look at all the efforts and all the people involved in this lie. It's obviously a big deal for fucking probably many reasons. It's not just some of the ones I named. There's probably 20 reasons I'm not even fucking aware of that there's a reason for the lie. But the lie is that massive. The deception is that big. And, like, dude, your kids are being brainwashed. That's the fucking thing that bothers me the most now. Your kids are being brainwashed. If I can show you that any of the footage is fake, say with the moon landing, right? The people that fucking drive me crazy, how can you think and they'll get to the point where they'll doubt the moon landing, but then they'll think the rest of it is real? It's like, dude, I'm not even just talking about, even if one space shuttle mission or something I could prove was fake, you should doubt all of it, honestly. But, because none of it should be fake, right? But if the moon landing is fake, why would you believe any of it?
Yeah, even the Challenger that exploded with the astronauts on it and the teacher that was on it and stuff, you know, that I think was done. Some people say it was some sort of a ritual for NASA, but on the level of having a tragedy like that happen brings people more into the lie. It's such a tragedy. It's more patriotic, you know, let's put the flags at half mast. And, you know, that was probably most likely another fake event. Nobody died and all this stuff like that. But there's always that emotional attachment that they link to it. And, you know, we're going to rise above this. We're going to, you know, blast off another shuttle and go further. And, you know, because we have to get past this tragedy and keep marching forward and stuff with all this patriotism and everything. So I think that's a huge part of it too, is just keeping that emotional attachment. Just recently, somebody had brought to my attention about the recent bang bangs that have been happening. And I was just like, you know, I don't even want to talk about it. Just, you know, it's all fake. I don't even know about these things happening unless somebody tells me about it, because I don't watch Tell Lies to Your Vision. So yeah, I just, there's a method to their madness, like I said, and we have to stop feeding into it. And one way that people can do that is to just literally unplug your TV and throw it in the fucking trash.
Yeah.
And then take your kids' mindsets back.
That's what I've been trying to tell people. Throw out the fucking TV. That was the first thing I did. I mean, I got rid of it. Once I knew that 9/11 and Apollo were fucking hoax, then I was done. I mean, what am I going to watch for? I mean, they're never going to show me anything real.
Yeah, I like the stuff that Russian Vids does on the SpaceX. He does some good stuff on that. That SpaceX thing is such a joke. I mean, literally, it just looks like they did rewind, and it just comes back. You know, it's just literally, it's so pathetic. I can't even believe people would buy that actually is taking place. Yeah.
People eat it up.
Yeah, they eat it up. They want it. That one right there, you could tell that's her.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that guy there. And they all have twins, too. Isn't that convenient, the twins and stuff? Yeah,
this guy says he's his twin. Oh, that's not me. That's my twin. There's two sets of identical twins on this one astronaut mission. And people laugh at us, and it's a fucking joke. It really is. I get aggravated, I'm telling you, because, like, I get it. You don't have to believe what I believe. We can go our own way. But when you're going to mock and ridicule me because I don't believe NASA, because I don't believe science and claims that, listen, no matter what science claims, and I'm not saying there's not real science, I'm not saying there aren't people smarter than me, but first of all, I don't think anybody's smarter than me just because they have a lab coat or degree or anything. But of course, there's people smarter than me and that have specialties in their field. But when something goes against my observations, my experience, and my sense, and my intuition now, then I'm not going to believe it on its face. It's going to be proven to me. And you're not going to prove something to me by basing a theory off another theory, off of a CGI picture, off of something that you say happened 5,000 fucking years ago that we'll never prove. And the world is, you know, the universe is this many billion years old because evolution, because you can't ever show us proof of fucking evolution, because that's a fucking hoax too. You can't ever show us proof of it. So you make up this crazy, 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 crazy long timeline that,
yeah,
you know,
and the missing link. There's always a missing link there.
Oh, we used to have a different North Star, but we're going to have another one, Thuban, but it's going to be in like 95 fucking trillion zillion gazillion years, so you'll be around to see it, but you know what, yeah, I mean? It's going to be there, and by that time, you'll probably be fucking a dog. You'll be a dog, and then the next time around, you'll be a fucking grasshopper, because you started out as a fucking amoeba. And then you turn into a monkey, and now you're fucking stuck to a ball that spins. People live upside down, but you don't see the spin. In fact, not only – here's the kicker about the curvature, right? We talk about the curvature, and we can't observe it. We can't test it. It's not there, right? And
you know what gets me? Hold on. What gets me is when they say, oh, well, they're just not up high enough. Oh, it's so big that you can't see the curve. Wait a minute. Their math says 8 inches per mile squared. Their math says it's like 26,000 miles across, okay? So that means at a certain point, you're going to be able to see a curve. At some point somewhere, the curve, it's going to slope off on the sides. But no, you never see that. Now, if you've flown on planes at night or during the day, and it's a clear day, which, you know, they have shit all chemtrailed up to where you can barely see 5 miles ahead of you, you could see the next city coming up. Or you would only, if it was a ball, you would only see the tops of the buildings until you got more closer to it, and then it would, you know what I mean? It does. It's all there. You can see it.
And here's the thing too: people will try and build straw man arguments of things that you're not going to be able to prove. Like they'll say shit like, "Oh, well, maybe you know the gravity is pulling the light around the ball," and all this crazy stuff, right? But listen. Before we even try and figure out a way to test if that's true or not, if it's indeed true, and it's indeed a ball, and there is indeed curvature, why are they faking it? Because they've been caught faking it time and time again. That's easy to prove. It's easy to show. Mythbusters, Red Bull, we can go on and on. Shots that they show at heights like this where they curve the lens, and this is all these balloons that we send up, and it's completely flat and level and stationary. But somehow we're the fucking idiots and we're the crazy ones. No, you motherfuckers will just get on your knees, bow down, fucking open your mouth and submit to the high priest of science. I'm not going to do that because I'm not a sucker. And I'm not saying you're a sucker if you don't believe what I believe. But if you believe fucking NASA and their bullshit and you just take it at face value when it fucking goes directly in the face of everything you fucking experience, you're a fucking sucker.
Okay, so did you say before that Houston, we've had a problem, has switched back to Houston, we have a problem? Or has that not
been? On the movie. Yes.
On the movie? Oh, okay, all right. Because the audio itself, it sounds like he still says we've had a problem, yeah.
Yeah, we've had, but the movie flip-flops, so the movie Apollo 13 went from Houston, we have a problem, to Houston, we've had a problem, and then back to Houston, we have a problem. Crazy.
Yeah. I just I'm trying to send you a link to my video here.
Hey, fuck NASA, okay?
Yeah. Fuck NASA.
Fuck Joe Rogan. Fuck Joe Rogan. I know that's your boy and all, but fuck Joe Rogan.
Joe Rogan ain't my boy.
There he is.
No, he ain't.
Yeah, he is.
Are you trying to say I'd fuck Joe Rogan? Not on a good day. All right. Hold on. All right, I just sent you a link to my latest video here. It's a really good song. I didn't make the song. I put the animation to it. But it's just the picture that you just had up there with the straight line and the sun right there. That pretty much most of the video has that in it. It's pretty good. I wouldn't copyright you or nothing if you played it.
I know.
But,
I have to put up Facebook and everything to do it. So how about we play when we get back? We'll take a quick break.
Yeah, that sounds good. Are you going to mute me or do I have to mute?
Either or.
All right.
You can do it, but if it's hard for you, I can do it.
No, I can do it. All right, so we're going to go on break?
Yeah, we're going to go on break. Give me a second. I'm just looking for my song. Okay, we'll be right back. Dose of Reality, True Seeker 69, Brian Staveley. We'll be right back. 5 minutes.
All right.
These are the tales, the silly tales. These are the tales NASA likes to tell. They've been enslaving mankind all this time, and we all know they'll be going to hell. See, I made up my mind when I was 33. I ain't with all
all the shit that they're feeding to me. I've been a slave for life. It don't feel right. People are in awe when Neil drops his mic. Many aren't just trolling. They're shilling like Rogan. But a higher power above has more hope for us, man. NASA bitches running space have so much greed. How is it possible that the public can't see? All globies do is bits, they never have any facts. Curvature don't exist and there's no stellar parallax. It's always flat at sea, and that's a fact. So what, we might not have the best map. It was 2014 when I first heard this flat earth stuff. 4 years deep and I really have learned so much. They're always doing CGI in the space station. A graphic artist is Rob Simmons' occupation. Tools fool zombies when they want, how they want to fool. The Jesuits and Masons influence all that we learn in school. I used to believe in the spinning globe. Didn't know the sun was near and the stars were close. Now we got long range pictures. What the men trying to say, it's not a legit image. They're just a blatantly lying bitches. They forgot to blast crater on the Apollo set. Neil Armstrong still won't swear on the Bible yet. So if you ever see a silly ISS outer space feed, don't believe those fakers are in anti-gravity. They simply aren't telling us the truth, folks. NASA is a friggin' Freemasonic joke. To them, galaxies are a dime a dozen, making up shit and no one can challenge them. Fuck Bill Nye and that crying box bitch. Brian's in the house with this hardcore truth of shit. We're not on a spinning pair. There's no curvature anywhere. We're not on a spinning pair. Ain't no satellites way up there. NASA's fake actors, they love to shill. Neil deGrasse Tyson, tell me how do you feel when you lie to us, so your masters keep us blinded. Looking for a curve, but you can't find it. On a globe, man, how we see Venus at night. Come on the broadcast, always lying about our life. Who you work for, is it the Masons or the Jews? Or the Vatican Jesuits saying, how can I serve you? Can't stand your whiny bitch, bald-ass Joe. How about when piss-stained beard Trevor was on his show? Coming up, I learned about shills and mo. Might deceive some, but you won't mislead me, though. NASA is full of friggin' green screens. 50 milli every day, jerseys from every team. I know I said it before, the Earth don't spin. And all the pics of Earth from space are blatant CGI, man.
Take on the role of the bridge to the communities. Might as well, since y'all wanna try and walk all over me. In the midst of the Great Awakening, you're worried about who found it first. Drop your ego, cause it's not a blessing, it's a fucking curse. The real true detriment to this awakening is fellow truth is fighting over such petty things. It doesn't matter if you're 9/11, Mandela, or Flat Earth. Even if you talk about the alleged nonstop from Chile to Perth. Even if you know that no airplanes came even near the towers. By not researching other topics, you're only enabling the ruler's power. Hiding knowledge is how they got to rule over us. Yet even knowing this, amongst each other, we still fight and fuss. It's time to stop the finger pointing, anointing someone as the next shill. You make Basil's accusations, and you claim you took the red pill. I am the bridge. I'll help put together the puzzle. You have a piece, I have a piece. So why go and apply our own muzzle? Let's progress the conversations and ignore the trolls. We already know their stories are completely full of holes. Not their fault, it was pushed by satanic assholes. Let's pool our research and drop the infighting. We can clash down on these bastards like a bolt of lightning. I know your reality shifting around can be so frightening, but don't be down, our consciousness is in the process of enlightening. Here to fight for the cause, we are all soldiers. Let our voice be heard as we outnumber them head over shoulders. There is no one ultimate truth. I thought that was 9/11. This was before digging into NASA and all their maskings of heaven. We don't know what happens when we die, or how the celestial bodies even hang in the sky. Don't act like you know it all, you're starting to sound like Bill Nye.
We need to know who put us here and why. Do you see what I'm saying? The game is far from over and we're all still playing. In the grand scheme of things, we don't know shit. But at least we admit, NASA and NIST did the opposite. And with the truth, they always hit it. Our strength is the truth is on our side. So our differences are futile. These are the people that showed us ridiculous debris pile. Planar, no planar, dome or no doma. Who gives a fuck from here to Oklahoma? We know it's flat. We know it wasn't Arabs. They had our minds in a coma. We know we had been deceived. Time to have a triumphant battle like Superman, Chris Reeves. We don't have to sit around and sing kumbaya, but open your mind and research more than one topic, would ya? It's all interconnected and essential to our progression. So why deal with all the infighting and pointless aggression? Voice your opinion, but respect others. And when you hear a topic you think is nuts, don't just hide under the covers. Where's your discernment at? Isn't that what you told that Globy when your gums were flat? Another thing you should know is we aren't having false memories. Time to trust your senses or get caught in their web and be stuck in their trenches. I'm here to knock down the fences and borders for them to hoard us into some camp. Give us some stamp. Come on, that shit is straight out of Alex Jones' FEMA board camp. Mark of the beast, you already tracked like that. Don't believe me? Where the hell's your motherfucking cell phone at? I'm here to broaden everyone's horizons. If you don't agree with all my points, I'm just fine with it. As you should be, able to sit down and still discuss it all with me. Sharing knowledge is the key, and ultimately how we're gonna finally break free. Like what I'm saying? I'm Brian Staveley, host of the rawest truth show around, Dose of Reality.
They see me revolving on the TV. I know they're all thinking I'm so round and curvy. Think I'm just too round and curvy. Think I'm just too round and curvy. Can't you see I'm NASA nerdy? Look at me, I'm NASA nerdy. I wanna float above the thermosphere, but so far gravity has got me stuck here. Think I'm just too round and curvy. Think I'm just too round and curvy. I'm just too NASA nerdy. I'm NASA nerdy.
First to my class base camp leak. Landed my module. First try with these. Buzz Aldrin cereal, yes please.
All right, everybody, welcome back. And again, we lose people when we go to break. I fucking hate that, but I get it. You know, let's see what else is going on real quick. You're not gonna find a fucking better show than this. Come on.
That's right. What's up? Whoop whoop. Make sure you guys put that number in the chat again for me, please. The call-in number. I might have some peeps calling in. You never know. Going on Philly on this show.
I'm going to put the phone up right now. You guys can call in. Phones are open. 978-435-0006. Call in. Call in to Dose of Reality. Talk to me. Talk to Truth Seeker. We were just bashing a little NASA. Fuck Joe Rogan. You know what I mean? Talking a lot of Mandela effect tonight, as usual. I do like to talk about NASA stuff, too. I don't talk about it as much as I used to because it's so fucking obvious to me, but everybody needs to wake up to this shit. I mean,
yeah, the whole thing with Donald Trump lately with that whole thing. Ugh, when I heard him say that bullshit, I was like, oh, here we go again. Of course, everybody starts scrambling and acting all crazy. Oh, they're going to put us away. You know what? They can't stop us. This is them running scared. When they're saying this kind of shit on TV, you know that we're getting to them.
I don't want to, like, you know, I'm not to, like, call the caller about that. They're getting the exact type of reaction out of you that they want.
Yep.
I just brush it off like this, dude. Like, yeah. You're gonna call me a flat tide. You're gonna call me a no plan. Even though I don't even want anything, they're gonna call me conspiracy theorist, kook job, moon landing denier. They're gonna call you fucking. Holocaust, and they're gonna, you know, I'm not gonna get into that, but they're gonna call you all these fucking names and you're anti-Semite, and even, you know, they're just gonna throw labels on you. You just gotta totally brush it off. And you gotta realize the people that are gonna accept the labels that are thrown on you and just believe it, well, those are the fucking people you're never gonna get through. Those are the people that aren't gonna get to the line in the sand with Apollo, Robbie Paca. They're just gonna accept all this person's a conspiracy theorist. Dude, anybody that owns a business is involved in conspiracies every fucking time they do a business deal. I mean, everything's a conspiracy. Give me a break.
That's right. Yep. And I've had every label put on me that you can imagine. It's just, It's old news. That's all it is. It's old news rehashed to be new rhetoric. And, you know, even with the Michio Kaku talking about the pareidolia and everything like that, what it is they're the ones who are really the crazy people. But this is what they do. Luciferians turn everything around, invert it, and throw it back at people who are actually putting the truth out. What they're projecting onto us is what they really are. They're the crazy, insane people who have some mental disorder, who are dysfunctional and want to pull us, our consciousness, over to their delusional side of reality and have us live their nightmare, their hell on earth for us, their matrix that they've created for us, a prison for our mind, our consciousness.
I don't fear none of it, dude. I know people probably think it's, you know, I think some people kind of get turned off by my attitude about it. They might think it's too kind of, oh, you know, I mean, obviously I care about this because I do it so much, right? And I'm putting everything I have into it. But at the same time, I don't have fear, nothing. There's nothing to fear. There's
you no can't grow and thrive when you're trapped in fear. Your consciousness is stunted when you live in fear.
Dose of reality around Brian and Truth Seeker. Who's this?
Hey, Brian, call for zero here. Hi, Truth Seeker.
Hey.
Yeah, no, I called a few weeks ago and I gave an example of like a malleable change of reality in a parking structure scenario. Well, I have another one.
Yeah, what do you got?
Well, there's a fellow at work, a coworker, and I'm giving him some examples of ME, and you know, he's okay. Yeah, well, I see that. Well, that's crazy, but he's not quite, you know, accepting it. But when I started mentioning changes around my living space, like my condo and things that have shifted, like, well, that wasn't there. That was different. Like the last time I even walked through the door. But anyway, he goes, you know what, man? He goes, you always do that to me. I got to tell you a story. And I said, well, what is it? And he said, a while back, I don't know, a year or two, he visited his sister. And she was saying, well, you know, the stairs going down in my basement, they're getting kind of creaky. And, you know, they really should be, you know, kind of made a little more solid. So he took it upon himself to, like, get sheets of wood, lay them on each stair, and he drove, you know, nails into the wooden stairs. So kind of made it more solid. And he thought, well, I'm going to put a screw in each corner of each cover on each stair just to make sure they stay there. So fine, you know, kind of helped. And then he was on the phone with her, I don't know, maybe a few months later after that. And she said, hey, you know, one of those covers you put on my stair has lifted up. And he said, well, you know, that shouldn't be. She said, yeah, it's coming loose. So he said, well, I put screws in all the corners, and so that shouldn't happen. So she went and checked it. The one that had come up had no screws.
Yeah.
None of the stairs had screws in them. Just nails.
That's crazy.
It is. Yeah. So
where did the conversation go from there? Then you were able to hit him with some more.
So I just said, it could be that somehow the house changed. It could be the person that actually worked on the stairs made a different decision then, and we're in the timeline. And I was just trying to explain what that could be to him. But he is, you know, so we both looked at each other and like, man, I don't know.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, the personal ones are the ones that really get people, man. Once you get them, it's crazy, man. Because I mean, that's just something. I mean, I can speak for, you know what I mean? My neighborhood changes. It's so crazy when that happens. Yeah, I don't know, man.
I got a blue spring around my brown eye. I shouldn't say brown eye. My brown eyes.
hey,
not that brown eye.
Let us all see your brown eye.
Yeah, I subscribed to your channel, and I saw that little short vid with that circle. Okay, take care, man. You can see your brother.
All right. Okay. Dose of Reality, you're on with Brian and Jen. Is this? This one's going south fast. Watch. Who's this?
Hello.
Hi, who's this?
Hello.
Hi, who's this?
Yeah, this is True Speaker's mom. I just called in. I don't know if I can say hi.
You can say hi. Okay, cool. I'm glad it's you. I didn't know who it was.
Hi, honey. I just wanted to know you guys are doing a great job. And I hope everybody is out there listens with, a clear mind, an open mind, and tells everybody the truth. We all need to be awoke. Me, one of them. I love you guys very much. I'm going to go now because I'm going to get sentimental.
All right.
Love you, Mom.
I love you guys.
I love you too.
And thank you.
You
so
do
much.
Do a good job. Love you.
Thanks, Mom. Love you too.
And okay. My mom, if you're watching, bye-bye. don't get any ideas. Yep. Goodbye.
Yeah, see, your mom's got to call in ideas. Now.
My mom's calling, and I'm fucking going to hang up on her and ban her from the channel.
Oh, yeah. I would like to talk to your mom. This explains so much.
You do not want to talk to my mother.
Oh, and I have something else to show you. This is my grandfather's hat I bought him. I'm actually going to put it on in his memory. Retired Army vet. And before he passed away, I asked him how many people were in the car when JFK was assassinated, and he said 4. And he had Alzheimer's. So even with Alzheimer's, he said there was 4 people in the car, and he knew that for sure. So when you're dealing with Alzheimer's and you really know that family member, you can tell when they come in and out of it, if they're confused or not. I'm sorry, I'm getting a little choked up. And he said 4. He knew there was 4. So I'm wearing this in honor of him. I keep it up on my mantle over here, and that's why I ask all the vets. So in honor of my grandfather. Anyway, just wanted to put that out there.
Look what Kyla wrote on the fucking screen.
Oh, I put my glasses back on. What's it say? If Brian's mom comes on, we're going to tell her to make him go to the dentist. with his jaw? Is that what you guys are talking about?
Yeah, he's saying, that bitch is saying I have ugly teeth.
Oh, no, you got straight teeth. They look good.
Yeah, I'm going to fucking smack her.
I'll hold her down, you smacker. Carla, don't her on you, girl. You don't want to go there. We love you.
Golden towel, motherfucker. Golden towel. Dose of Reality, you're on Brian and True Seeker. Who's this?
What's good, my brother? It's Burgos.
Hey, what's up, Burgos?
Hey, what's good, my brother? Let me just pause this. Hold on. You guys are doing great, man. Great show tonight.
Thank you.
Okay.
No, you're welcome. No echoes or anything, right?
No, you're good.
Okay, good. Cool. Brian, I don't know, man. You know what really upset me today?
What's that?
The way they're attacking Blaze, man.
I don't know. I don't want to get involved in that, though. You know what I mean?
No, I figured that. I just wanted to say, like, real quick.
Yeah, that's cool.
But it really... I don't think it's. I know his heart. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. I like Blaze. How you got? I like Blaze a lot. He's supposed to come back on the show soon, actually. But you know what I mean. I don't want to get involved in shit-slinging back and forth between people. So.
Yeah, I
say, like, do what Brian does. Just don't even feed into it. Don't give them the power. Don't even answer them. And that's the way I handle it too. But some people feel they have to address those types of things, and that's the road that they need to go down. But
exactly. Ignore that kind of comments and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, because this community is supposed to be united. We're not supposed to fight against each other or anything. I mean, we're going through the same scary thing.
It's scary for a lot of people. For me, it's fascinating. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, I know exactly.
Yeah,
what you mean.
For me, the experience. Yeah, it's fascinating for me, and it's supposed to unite us instead of divide us. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
I agree. I think some of these people are put in place to put out some videos and then come and create that division. And that might be what some of these people are up to. you know, there's some shady characters out there.
I hear that. Oh, by the way, God bless your mom, man.
Thank you.
The last uncle, that was your mother, right? Yeah, God bless her. You know, that kind of support is crucial.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, we had a rough start. My family was thinking I was on the crazy side when I first came out with a lot of this stuff years and years ago. And they've really turned a corner and they support me 100%. And I really appreciate it. And I'm so grateful that I was able to wake them up and they're no longer deceived. Yeah.
That's a great thing because, you know, I've been driving. I'm not driving currently, but I've been driving a yellow cab in New York City. Since 2000, you know, and I started noticing, like, of course, you know, I'm out there, car logos, you know, the Home Depot, you know, you're out there, so you have to be aware of everything because you're driving. You don't want to, you know, you have to be aware.
Yeah.
And when I mentioned a couple of these changes to my family, they were like, it's just company logos being changed. You know, I'm like, okay, you know, but I didn't know anything. I didn't know better until maybe 8 months ago when I discovered your channel, Brian.
Mm-hmm.
And the funny thing is that I discovered your channel through Secure Team 10.
How's that?
Because he has, because he has just one Mandela effect video.
Yeah.
You know, and like I started watching this video because, you know, I've been into UFOs and stuff like that. And then after I saw his video, I punched in the Mandela effect and your channel came up. And that's how I discovered you. And then when I saw, like, what you exposed on the video, that's when I said, wait a minute, I'm not going crazy. You know, because even shopping at the supermarket, I started noticing, like, Jiffy wasn't there anymore. Idaho is now Idahoan. You know, the box of mashed potatoes. I don't know if it was like that.
I didn't know that the potatoes changed. Yeah, I didn't know that one.
Exactly. Yeah, you know, Febreze, all this stuff on my local, I'm a local deli, but I had no idea because I didn't discover you guys when this happened. And then when I saw your video, I'm like, oh my God, I'm not going crazy. And, you know, the support from my family has been great because they thought it was just one of those phases when you discover new things and you're, like, curious about it and whatever. But my father's a very, you know, like, grounded person. But the thinker statue got him 100%.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then right after, right after the bananas going upwards.
Dominican
Republic, man. Come on, man. You know.
Yeah, them bananas are weird.
This, I grew up, you know, I was born here, raised in Dominican Republic, you know, until I was 22 years old. I used to come every summer to New York, but bananas, come on, man. Every backyard, there's a freaking plantain.
Yeah.
You know, and then chickens flying. Por favor, you know, it's like, you know.
Well, next it's going to be pigs pigs fly.
Yeah, no, they do fly now. They never flew like that. And one of my top five is Centerville, changes to Centerville. I know you know that. Fine.
Yeah. I didn't think it was going to resonate with anybody when I did it. And a lot of people have told me it was big for them. Couple people told me that woke them up to the Mandela effect.
Yeah, of course, man. I mean, it's you, first of all, you know, and you're a very solid, truthful person, you know. And it's not about accent. It has nothing to do with having an accent. central and center is not the same thing. Center and central is not the same thing.
Yeah.
You know.
Not even close.
And that flag on the stone monument?
Yeah.
You know, with the red right under the blue?
Yeah.
You know, it tells you a lot, man. It's kind of fading away, by the way.
Yeah, but on the backside, it's not, which is crazy, because I didn't know. Did you know? I didn't know there was a backside. So the one on my channel, it's fading away, right? And then me and Nora, and she went around to the backside of it because there's a one-way street that runs behind it. There's no reason for me to ever be up there. And look at the backside here. I have it on the screen grab right now if you have it up.
You got to be kidding me, man.
And look at the flag on the ground. Look at the flag behind me on the ground. It's the new flag with the old flag monument.
That's a really good catch.
Yeah, totally, man. Totally. So, yeah, man, you know, like when you drive a yellow cab, a cabbie in New York City, you know, you notice all these things because you have to be aware of everything. And that information I got unknowingly from 2000 till 8 months ago, it was in the back of my mind resting there, you know, because it was weird. You know, come on, a Volkswagen with this dash in between.
Yeah. My first car that I ever bought. Not the first car I ever bought, but the first brand new car I ever bought, which was the second car I ever bought. It was a 1997 Jetta, and there was no gap, bro. 100%.
No gap.
I mean, I looked at the emblem 100%. All the time. I had to replace the emblem at one time because somebody stole it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and you know, it makes you wonder, you know, am I going crazy? Did they change the logo? Did they change let me tell you, in the Caribbean, for example, Dominican Republic, we usually you go there and you see a lot of European cars.
Yeah.
So it wasn't something, you know, like, you know, we have the Volkswagen, we have a couple of other cars right now. I can't remember. You know how it is when you're talking and you want to have it on the spot. I can't remember right now, but there's a lot of European cars in Dominican Republic, and Volkswagen is one of the most.
Yeah, I went to Cancun, Mexico once, and I remember seeing a lot of Volkswagens in Mexico. I was like, wow, this must be where all the Volkswagens go when nobody wants them anymore. They all go to Mexico because they were everywhere. Like, made little taxis out of them and stuff.
Which is what happens in the Caribbean. You know, there's a lot of European cars, you know, Mercedes, Volkswagen. There's another one that has like a kind of a tiger. I forget the name. And,
Jaguar?
I'm sorry?
Is it Jaguar?
Not the Jaguar. It's another one. The logo has like a, not like a Pantera, like speeding up like that, but it'll come to me sometime.
The Subaru symbol has a huge space, a vacant spot on it where a star used to be. It was seven stars on the Subaru symbol logo. And it was for the Seven Sisters of Pleiades.
Yeah,
and now there's only six stars. And where the seventh star would be, it's just completely blank, open. It's just this huge open space right there. It's like bizarre looking.
Right. Another thing, another change or something new. Not a change, but it's something new. There's a beach in Puerto Plata, which is, you know, the beach area in Dominican Republic, which runs parallel to a river.
Yeah.
Okay? And we love the river in the Caribbean. You know, we love the river. And you don't tell me that didn't exist? I'm 48, bro. And I grew up there until I was 25, until I decided to come back to New York. And you know, I used to go to the beach to Puerto Plata and Sosua, which are the area, the beach areas most famous, Dominican Republic. A river, parallel, like five steps away, you get into the salt water, and then you go and take a shower in the sweet water. You know what I mean? That's crazy.
That is crazy.
Totally crazy. And I'm sure there's a thousand changes in the Dominican Republic. I'm not there. And people hardly speak about it, but I'm sure there is. And I've been trying to tap into, to tap into a couple of programs of channels from the Dominican Republic. And I've asked the question to what they think about the Mandela effect. No one has responded yet, but I'm sure soon enough it will in the near future, because it is happening. I mean, this is 100% real. You know, no one has to convince me. I know it is real. As crazy as it sounds.
Way past the point of convincing. It's like I tell people, when I know a Mandela effect, I don't need the residue. That's just to convince other people, you know? And because I want to love it and have it saved. But, I mean, you know, I know. I just know inside. I don't need – when my neighborhood changed on the river, you think I needed the residue?
Now, your neighborhood's change is crazy, Brian. It's totally crazy. I mean, it took you 2 months to even come out and talk about it. Because I know you were trying to digest this. It's like I live in New York. It's like tomorrow is going to be Old York. You know what I mean? Or something like that. I don't know. You know, it's crazy, man. But anyway, man, I'm not sure if I exceeded the 15 minutes. I had so many things to say, and now I can't. I'm blanked because I'm surprised I was even able to get through. But keep doing what you've been doing, guys. And
I love you guys. And
thank you. I'm a truth seeker, Brian, and so many other channels. All right, brother?
Thank you.
All right, man. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. We'll talk soon, Brian. Yo, dude. Go to your email, man. I sent you a fresh residue about Field of Dreams from New York One. Check it out, bro.
All right, cool.
All right? All right, guys. I'll keep listening, all right?
All right.
All right, bye. Bye-bye.
All right, that was Burgos.
Burgos.
So, yeah, there's a lot of personal, local changes in the land and stuff for people that are happening. More and more people are talking about it. There's one out here, too. I don't know, Lumpy, if you're still in the chat, but there's a company here called Maycom. And it changed to Maycom with one A. It used to have a double A, which is not something you're going to fabricate or like a silent ed and dilemma. You know what I mean? The company was called Maycom with a double A, and now it's Maycom with a single A. It looks fucking ridiculous.
That would be Maccom, not Maycom.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where are these letters going? You know, they're going somewhere. I don't know.
Yeah. So I don't know. Time for another call or two.
Pull up that Subaru symbol if you can. Can you do that? Subaru?
Yeah, hang on. Let me open up another window. Hang on. I'll do it while we talk.
All right.
What's the reality around with Brian and Jen? Who's this? Hello.
Hey.
Hey, who's this?
This is Christian.
What's up, dude?
Hi.
How you doing, man?
I'm good. How are you?
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Good. I couldn't believe, dude, when I was in Lowell the other day, and I couldn't turn left to go over the bridge because I missed the cones and stuff. And so I had to turn right, and that's going, like, right into Centerville.
Yeah.
And the very first sign I see, and I've never seen anything like this gas station, it says New World.
Yeah.
And it's like, I've seen a lot of gas stations in my time. I've seen all the chains. I've driven around the country a lot of times, and I've seen a lot of different chain convenience stores. I've seen Wawa in Philly, of course, you know, and never in my life have I seen New World.
That's the name of it. I didn't even know that was the name of it.
Yeah, that's when you drive into Centerville.
Yeah, the gas station on the right. I thought that was called Pace.
No, it's called New World.
That's news to me as well, by the way. That might be a new change itself. Because I thought that was a Pace gas station. That's what I always say, take me to Pace.
No. And I've never heard, dude, Cumberland Farms, all the different chains. I've never seen a convenience store gas station called New World. But it's right there at the beginning of Centerville. Thought that was pretty twisted.
This place is really shifting, man.
Yeah, the logo, by the way, is like a globe with three people, you know, holding hands around the globe.
Yeah.
I just thought that was weird. But also someone just posted a tweet that Tommy Lee, I guess the drummer for Motley Crue.
Yeah.
He posted an anti-Trump thing that was in his tweet. He listed Joel Osteen should get a job at Chick-fil-A. And
oh,
both
no
of
way.
Them are yeah. Joel, and it was Chick, C-H-I-K, Filet, F-I-L-A, which is wrong, too. So he, he hasn't gotten the updates on either of Joel Osteen at Chick-fil-A. C-H-I-C-K is the way it's currently spelled, right?
I'm not even sure anymore. I know it used to be C-H-I-C. Then there was a C-H-I-C-K and a C-H-I-K, I think, yes. I think it's C-H-I-K now. And the A also changed at the end from either lowercase to capital or vice versa. So there was four changes,
yeah.
four versions, at least three changes.
It's Chick-fil-A. When I looked it up on Wikipedia, it was Chick, C-H-I-C-K-F-I-L-A. But it was in one sentence. He basically, you know, is butchering the, you know, listing basically a couple major Mandela effects in the one sentence.
Yeah.
But I was just thinking, you know, as you talk about what seems to be the commonality, like, do you ever spend any time trying to figure out, like, what are the patterns that you're seeing and the patterns of things changing and, like, you know, just like, The reason I ask that is because I'm just wondering, some of the words are really interesting that end up changing, like, you know, who will save their souls, you know, so the word is souls, and you're like, okay, that's interesting, and then, like, the city of angel, so it's angel, right, you know, and you just kind of, like, they're interesting things that get chosen as you know, changes. And
yeah,
I'm wondering,
like,
if there's, like,
there.
Any
it's
say
like
that again
message. Like a message that's being portrayed through these changes. I see messages sometimes, you know, the city of angel, that's Lucifer, who will save your souls, Jesus, your soul's supposed to be saved through Jesus, where they're mocking Jesus, saying, ha ha, like, who will save your souls now, you know, like, we got you. That's kind of the way I was taking it when I heard that one. I thought, wow, that's like a slap in the face. Who will save your souls? You know, where are you going? Nowhere. That's where you're going. You know what I mean? And somebody
yeah.
might
maybe they're meant to draw our attention to something, you know, like, about someone or, you know, you know,
yeah,
if
that's what I was saying. I think the Bible changes might be when people think it's bad. I think it might be, hey, like, look at this. Hey, look at the wolf is lying with the lamb now. You know what I mean? Like, watch out type of thing.
Yeah, I totally agree with
yeah,
that. The
exactly.
wolf is lying with the lamb. Absolutely. It is a true statement. However, of course, we all remember it was not like that. It was another way. And it's been supernaturally changed retroactively right back to the beginning of the inception of this Bible. So, but there's a clear message
yeah.
there, and it's definitely true.
Yeah, I think I told you once before, like, when my wife and I, like, when we have that moment of synchronicity where it's like you say a word at the same time, or, like, she's typing the word, you know, and I say it, right, and it's a random occurrence. Well, you know, if you take those words and you put them into a sentence, like, anytime you see something that is, like, you know, a synchronous kind of event between, like, two people that, and you kind of look at each other and you go, whoa, that was like, I was just saying that, you know, or I just had typed that or something like that. You take those words and you put them into a sentence, and it's an interesting message that it forms, you know, at least for us, you know, we've got this, like, ongoing cosmic sentence that, you know, is pretty interesting. It's almost like a Ouija board. And I'm wondering if it's like, you know, the Mandela effect is like a bunch of different elements that you've kind of put together, and you get like, or it's just drawing you to, you know, really look into something. I don't know, like you take something like Black Tom, and I don't know where you would go with that, but, you know, maybe there's like a Black Tom that is something that is, you know, you should look for, you know. Are there any Black Toms that in history that, you know, or any recent events with a guy named Tom that happens to be black or whatever?
Tom,
you know,
Hanks. Like, Tom Hanks is really black.
Tom Hanks with a suntan.
Tom Hanks!
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
Let me just welcome Flat Earth Falker. He's on here real quick. He jumped in. I don't know if you can see him, but Mac, what's up?
What's up, guys? Hey, Brian. Hey, Jen.
Hey.
Good show. I've been listening to pretty much all of it. Very good show today.
Thanks.
Yeah.
See how easy it is to get in here? You just click the link, bro. All I did, Mac, is I set up the show. Like, I literally title the show. I hit public or whatever I want. I can schedule the time. And then I hit create broadcast. It brings me right into this room, and I run everything right in. I just send links. Nobody has anywhere.
Do you start in YouTube?
No, you just start right here, but you just link your YouTube account to it. It asks you to sign in one time. That's it. You create broadcast, and then it makes the event on your YouTube page, just like if you did it the old way.
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's worked so easy. Hey, Christian, you got any, you know, Falker? You got anything you want to ask Falker? Because he just got on here.
No, there was just one other recent event that I thought, I know you like to bash Neil deGrasse, and he really got himself into some hot water with the recent events where the shooting, he tweeted something that was like, you know, about the statistics of getting shot or something like that.
Yeah,
I saw that.
Yeah, compared to like other deaths from other things. Yeah.
But I do have something for Falker, and I know like, a little bit about his story about waking up and everything like that. But one of the things that really did it for me before even 9/11 was the Iran-Contra scandal, if you guys ever looked into that. But like the bottom line is a lot of shady stuff was going on. But the bottom line was our own government was bringing in drugs to our own country. And it was like a real wake up call for me that like, oh my gosh. And I had like all the proof I needed, and there's all kinds of congressional hearings and stuff like that kind of, you know, the Ali Noor stuff that you saw on TV and it's just kind of like the surface. Yeah. But if you trace back the origins of crack cocaine in this country, it's a plot from our own government to bring drugs in and sell them in the inner cities. And
so was the whole rap music scene, but the whole gangster rap music scene was to go along with that and to put people in the private prison industry. That's all one big circle jerk.
Yeah, that was like the quadruple whammy, was that while they brought this stuff in, they were able to like increase the prison sentences while they owned the prisons. So they started putting all these people in jail for possession of a small amount of crack cocaine.
Possession of drugs that they brought in, they glorified, they sold, and then they upped the laws to keep people in the prisons longer.
And they are. You look at these investment groups, and they're all of these big government people, you know, the Bushes and stuff like that, where they bought the prisons, and they basically had the contracts with the state to have all of these guys taken away and thrown in. And when I started really going down this path of like understanding what happened in that whole scenario, and you know, what is very easily provable in all kinds of different ways, you know, planes went down, our own US government airplanes went down with all this crack cocaine in it. And how do you explain that? Well, there are congressional hearings that were completely controlled by, you know, these different people that, you know, basically were able to kind of push all this stuff under the rug so that it doesn't come out, because they know that if it came out that people started waking up to the fact that they were being drugged by their own government, that it would be like, you know, a major, major, you know, crisis on their hands. So they basically handled it in closed door congressional hearings, and then, you know, and then moved on from it. So, you know, a lot of these players just continued on their political careers and everything like that. No one, very few people got any kind of like, you know, any kind of reprimand or anything like that. They said that they tried as best they could with the congressional hearings to get Bush Senior to talk, and he wouldn't talk, you know. And so they said that there's a real cloud. They called it a cloud overhanging the Oval Office, because the vice president is basically all roads lead to him, and he's not, you know, he's not cooperating with us. He won't talk about anything.
They call him Poppy Bush. They used to call him Poppy Bush.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the CIA, yeah, exactly. The CIA were the biggest fucking cocaine smugglers in the world.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's unbelievable. Like, you know, even before 9/11, I was like so opened up to the idea that some crazy shit was going on, you know, like, that was kind of like, oh my gosh, the government is not my friend at all. Like, you know, and it all just kind of gets whitewashed as this epidemic that's sweeping the country, you know, just kind of like randomly taking over the world, like, crack. But, you know, it was all targeted, and it was all planned out, and it was all being made happen by our own government. And so, you know, before even looking into 9/11, you kind of like get the story of that, and then your mind's kind of prepared to understand bigger truths. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. I know exactly what you're saying. If I didn't go, if I didn't go through 9/11 and that reality breakdown, it'd be pretty hard for me to deal with the Mandela effect.
Look what they've done to the American people over the years. We're slow, sick, dying, obese, and everybody's drugged up. And even if you think you're not on drugs, if you're drinking tap water and your water's fluoridated, you're taking in a substance into your body that's changing your chemistry and having you react to things differently because of this foreign chemical that's been introduced to your body. So yes, you are being drugged. And there's all other kinds of things in the water as well. So, I mean, they couldn't take the guns away from us. So they got people just so sick, dying, drugged up, and everything else that, you know, we're a shell of what we used to be as far as, you know, back in the 40s and the 50s, where we were more robust, had more gusto, were more willing to, you know, take these risks and stand up and speak out. You know, people today, they're just like, they're so docile. Hitler used fluoride in the concentration camps to keep them all docile and, you know, not wanting to leave or try to even attempt to break out or anything. That's why he put the fluoride in it. They knew for a long time what fluoride does to the body, what it does to your mind. And in the end, it creates Alzheimer's, because if you drink fluoridated water all your life, you're in a city and you don't know any better. You got 50, 60, 70 years of fluoride in your system built up because it accumulates, doesn't go anywhere. Your body stores it in your bones. You're going to have major problems, and you probably won't even remember your name or who your family is or how to wipe your ass. So,
yeah,
it's quite diabolical.
It's pretty clear that they want you dead by a certain time too. Okay. You know, it's like, you know, they want you to kind of like be around so that they can kind of milk you for what you're worth in the system. And then it's like, and then, you know, when you hit that age, you know, especially veterans, I'll tell you, you know, you were talking about your grandfather and stuff like that. I've got a lot in my family that, you know, it's pretty clear that the VA, you know, and you know, just kind of the care that you receive is meant to go so far. But, like, I don't know that they really want soldiers living to the ripe age of 100 or something like that. They kind of want you gone by 70.
They don't want you around long enough to pass on information past too many generations, because then they can't get that information.
We used to go to our elders for information. We would go to the elders for our knowledge and our wisdom. They took that away from us. Our elders don't even know their names anymore. They're babbling, they're drooling on themselves. I encourage everybody, if you ever have an opportunity, go visit an Alzheimer's unit. I had the unique, I can't say pleasure, to work in an Alzheimer's unit for a short period of time. And let me tell you, it's scary. I was just literally, because these people were local to my area and they used to have careers here. People knew them. I mean, they were newscasters, all kinds of stuff. And when you see how they are now, it's like, oh my gosh, it's an epidemic. It's been put here for a reason, and we're all subject to it. I mean, if you've even with the flu shots, 10 flu shots in your lifetime, you're going to have Alzheimer's. And, you can research that out on your own. I've done a video about it years ago, but yeah, it's very disturbing if you ever have a chance to go to an Alzheimer's unit and see people in different phases of Alzheimer's, and it affects everybody differently. It's not always the same. Each person's the same. I can't even begin to tell you how
Christian,
sad.
I'm gonna let you bounce just because we're up on 20 minutes, all right, brother?
Yeah, good talking to you guys.
Thank you.
So, Mac, what's up, dude?
What's happening? It's good to see you guys. You guys are all upbeat and cheerful. I'm having a desperado day. And I was listening to you guys. I go, let me jump in here and steal some of your energy.
Jump in head first.
Why don't you tell us what you're thinking? Anything you want to comment on that you heard, or just something you want to bring up? What's up?
No, man. I mean, like, we could talk forever. Thinking about the Mandela effect, just with everything that's going on in the life, and interactions with people here, I don't have a number one Mandela effect. There's like a name off 10, 15 of them. They're all number one. You know what I mean? It's like I know my memory. Like I know what I remember. So as I notice more and more, the last couple of days, it's like the Matrix is just sending people, or the system, or the screen, whatever you want to call this reality. Like, honestly, there is something bigger at play here, and I just feel it. Like, before I could brush it off to maybe people's behavior, or somebody's got some mental problems, something like that. But nah, man, I just feel like through the NPCs is what the Matrix is doing, is sending people to just test me and just aggravate me and push my buttons.
Did you hear me and Nora talking? Did you hear me talking about me and Nora and the Boston Strong guy?
You know what? I listened to that show. I might have missed it, but I didn't.
No, I said it tonight. I said it tonight. I didn't say it today. I forgot to mention it that day. And listen, this is going to go right into what you say, and then I'll let you take the floor again. So she was telling me, because we were sitting in the diner, and we were talking about these types of events, and the one in Boston came up. And then we started talking about, about all the T-shirts that were sold, the Boston Strong shirts. Uh-huh. And she was talking about, she's going and visiting different people. So she was talking, let me put the camera on both of us. So she was talking about how she went to this place, and there was one of those bang bang events recently. Then she went to another one, and so she's like, is this thing like following me? Like, what if there was like a shooting or something here in Lowell right now, even if it was, fabricated or whatever? Like, that would be crazy, right? I'm like, yeah, that would be real crazy. So then we started talking about the marathon. She started talking about going in and actually, into shops and talking to people, we talked deep about it, right, as we're having breakfast. And then she started talking about is this type of stuff following me? We started talking about the Boston Strong t-shirts and how it wasn't just people that are buying into it and selling t-shirts. It's like Nike. It's Under Armour. They're printing these things out by the thousands and millions of Boston Strong t-shirts, right? So we have this conversation. I pay the bill. We pay the bill. We get in the Uber. And we go over to Top Donut to go see the Centerville sign. As we pull into Top Donut, Mac, you're going to love this. As we pull into Top Donut, I look over. Out of the corner of my eye, the door's already swinging open. Homeboy fucking comes out. Fucking Boston Strong t-shirt like this, bro. Just like...
That's a synchronicity.
It goes right into what Mac's saying. Go ahead, Mac. There you go. I want to tell you that.
That's like crazy. Well, it makes me feel better to know that I'm not alone. That's noticing this stuff. Like I go to Denny's today to meet a good friend of mine. You know, my best friend, cause just, I'm going through some tough, you know, stuff here. And, we haven't sat down and chatted in a few weeks and I was away. So I go to pay and you know how my money's got writing on it. So the chick takes the money away, and I was actually thinking, oh, this chick's the young girl is friendly, and you know, this pretty good, pleasant service, not bad. And because you know, I've been getting bad, you know, what do I think about service when going out to eat? So then I go to pay her after, right? And you know, give her a little healthy tip as well, but I did need some change back. And she comes back and goes, oh, this money has writing on it. Do you have some other money without writing on it? And then I'm like, no, what's wrong with the writing on there? And she's just like, well, the banks probably won't accept it. And I'm like, dude, you're like thinking in my head, you're like half my fucking age trying to tell me like what the banks are gonna fucking accept here. And I'm like, and she goes, and the rest of the money as well. And then I pull out all the cash I have and I lay it on the table. I go, all my money's got writing. There's no problem. I use it all the time. The banks will take ripped money. You could tape up currency and the bank will take it. They're supposed to take it, right? At least here in Canada, the money could be taped up. I don't know, down in the U.S.
Pretty much, as long as you have more than half the bill, most places will take it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so, and can I just say, I used to write all over my money too. I can't believe you're saying this. I stopped a long time ago, but I used to write like 9/11 was an inside job. I put websites on there, put all kinds of stuff. $100 bills, 50, doesn't even matter. Ones, it's free advertisement.
Yeah, if people want to avoid you leaving business cards, flat earth business cards and stuff, they can avoid it. But if they need to take that money, they need to take that fucking money.
Yeah. I think it's so cool you write on your money. That's awesome. I'm going to start doing it again.
Yeah. Why did you stop? You just got lazy and forgot? Or?
Yeah, I got lazy. That's what it was. I just moved on to other topics and started researching other things and kind of moved away from the 9/11 thing. This was early on when I was really passionate about getting the word out about 9/11 being an inside job, even though I didn't understand fully how inside it was. But I was trying any way possible to get the word out, and I decided, you know what? I'm writing all over my money, because I worked at a restaurant. I had a lot of tip money and stuff, and I would just, you know, it was always in my wallet. I'd be giving it to somebody for change or whatever.
Yeah, I mean, in the U.S., I just came back from the States. So there's a stamp, Research Flat Earth stamp that I have, that you stamp them. So it's nice and quick.
Yeah, I've seen those.
And Canada, like this plastic money, that ink doesn't stick to it. So I got to get a Sharpie. So I got to sit there and write on every single bill. On one side, I write stoplookthink.com, because I used to write Earth is flat. But I'm like, oh, that's triggering these NPCs too much. So I put David Weiss's website on there now, because it's got all the fake bang bang shootings. It's got everything on there, chemtrails. I don't know if you've been to stoplookthink.com. And in the back, I write NASA lies, Eric debate, 200 proofs. That's all I write, 200 proofs. I don't write spinning ball or anything, not on a spinning ball. But like Brian says, like a card or a pamphlet they take, they're going to chuck it away. Money. $20 bill, even if it's a $1 bill.
And it gets passed
bill.
Around to so many people. It'll just keep going and going and going.
Yeah, it's going to hit many, many eyes.
Yeah.
So I encourage everybody to do it. So you should start doing it again. And
I will. Yeah. I promise. I'm going to do it. I am.
So anyways, it was just kind of like, I was just kind of like aggravated, because I'm feeling kind of down already. And now this kid's coming. I go, you know what? Go talk to your manager. So obviously, you know, these millennial NPCs, they don't know shit about life. And she comes back, and like, took her a long time talking to the manager. He comes back and says, okay, well, we'll take it today, but next time you come in, just make sure you have money without writing on it. And I'm just like, what the fuck? It kind of aggravated me. And then here at my business today, somebody's been coming here for a while. I don't want to get into the exact details, but you know, they just did something that was just fucking retarded. And I'm just like, who the fuck is this fucking person that did something that's totally against, you know, what our rules and policies are? And I just started shaking. I did not know how to deal with this person, because it just caught me at like such a time that was completely unopportunistic for me, but for the Matrix triggering me and setting me off, it was like the perfect time for this situation and this person that must have taken some kind of fucking download to come and aggravate me with, right?
Yeah, they're gatekeeping you. That young girl, that NPC, that the Matrix set her to gatekeep you. And that's what that, you know, I always tell people, I'm like, are you censoring me? Don't fucking censor me. Don't tell me what to say or do or what to write. Fuck you.
And you know what? I sat here
trying to censor my ass.
And then I felt like I was gaslit. And I go to my buddy who's just kind of laughing because he knows me, but he's like a, you know, child of the Matrix. And somebody's here who's gatekeeping. It's people, NPCs are gatekeeping, awake and sane. So I said to my buddy, I'm like, hold on a sec. Maybe this is a Mandela effect. Maybe they changed the law. Because the way she talked about it, she was so confident, and the banks won't take this money.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh my God, did the law change? Is it a new law? Because I can see it coming. I can see the Matrix. One second. Huh?
Yeah, people trying to gatekeep other people and stuff. Oh, well, next time you come in, you better have the right money.
Yeah, and then, sorry, I wasn't listening. What was I saying? Yeah, so then I thought, oh, man, this would be a huge Mandela effect that maybe the law changed, or it's always been illegal to write on money and the banks don't take it. Anyways, it's just a weird fucking feeling. It was like a shot in the gut, both sides, so, and in the balls.
Wow. Yeah, well, that was really odd the other day, coming in, Nora. Like I said, we were talking about that same situation. And then as soon as we left, we seen the guy with the boss. Dude, it was like, dude, I flipped out when I seen it. Like, I was like, dude, my heart dropped. And I was like, did you just fucking see that? Because we were still in the car. She's like, yeah. I'm like, look at this motherfucking, look at this guy. He literally, bro, we would just have a whole conversation about those shirts. Dude, just all of a sudden, as soon as we pulled in Top Donut, where everything's going down. You got the Centerville sign, that Centralville with the old flag next to the new flag on the ground with the Merrimack River residue on the wall. And then you fucking got this fucking shit going down right there. It's fucking crazy, man. I don't know.
Yeah, that seems like synchronicity. Like, you know, you're just talking about it and then you see the guy with the shirt and everything. I think that's, you know.
I see the guy with the shirt. He wasn't there. Like, you know how I said I've been seeing shit out of the corner of my eyes and my peripheral vision and, like, I seen the doorway already. There was nobody there. And, like, just in the matter of, like, a half of a second, the door was swinging open, and the guy with the Boston Strong shirt was fucking coming through the door like this, dude. Boom, read it. You know what I mean? Like, fucking, boom, right here, motherfucker. You call me?
I think that's life telling you you're on the right track. You're onto something. Keep going down that road because, you know, you're connecting those dots, and they need to be connected. I think it's really important to pay attention to these synchronicities because I've noticed with the Mandela effect, there's a lot more synchronicities. And you guys were talking before about manifesting and co-creating during this time. Because right now the veil's being lifted and we are starting to see for, you know, all their fruits and who these people are and what's going on and how we've been so deceived. And, you know, I think that we're also able to collectively come together and start manifesting what we want. Do we even know what we want? We've been taught lies all of our lives. We know we don't want the lies anymore. We don't want the bullshit. And we already know that the truth isn't pretty. It's pretty ugly is what it is. So we need to manifest. We need to first come together and agree that we can manifest this stuff. Because it's already shifting before our eyes. That's reality telling us it's not what you think. You can do something with this. Look, it's changing. You can change it. And people have on personal levels have been manifesting things. You know, some people don't realize it at first, even though it's there and it's happening. They'll come up with an excuse for it. Oh, it just happened to be that way. I just got lucky this time. Well, I tell you what, I can manifest a parking lot really close to the front doors of where I work every fucking time I go there. And it could be crowded as fuck. And I'll just roll right in and turn and a car will be pulling out for me. My mom has witnessed it many times. I'm like, see, I said, I'm already grateful my spot's waiting for me before I even get here. And when I get here, I roll up, 10 cars already went around. I'm pulling right in.
Yesterday, since Cynthia Sulazan was talking about when we did the show, me, her, Gloria, and Nathaniel, she was talking about she was at her sister's or whatever, and her family's like, they're open to what that is now, and she's like talking about manifesting things. They asked her because her like dryer was broken, the dishwasher. Can you do that thing you do? She's like, oh, like fix it. And I'm like, oh, so this whole time we're talking about there isn't no Mandela burglar. You are the fucking Mandela maintenance man.
Yeah, manifesting.
Like that happen. I'd be like, oh, one thing, it's broke 1 minute, and then it's like, it's fine. I don't know what happened. I guess it fixed itself.
Yeah. What were we saying, Falka?
Oh, the parking spot one is a big one. Like, if you have positive energy, that one works so many times. I find if I'm in a negative state of mind, I'm like, I hope there's parking. There's never parking.
Yeah.
You know, if I'm just relaxing, oh, I'm going to get parking right up close, or I don't have to walk, and there it is. The parking spot is an easy one to manifest.
Yeah. And it's fun. It's fun to start out that way because you can work your way up. People are already preconceived notions that this won't work. It will never happen. And if you're staying in that mindset and that vibrational energy, it won't. So you have to understand how to play the game, I guess, is manifestation. And we've never been taught this. So we have to learn it on our own. We have to figure it out collectively. And, you know, we're going to have some bumps along the way and things aren't going to work out. But I think, you know, this is a key component to the knowledge that's been kept from us.
Well, I mean, the information's been out there. If you, like, so much of the population got into the New Age movement, and it does give you some truths, but another pigeonhole, like religion. But again, there's a lot of truths in there. So, you know, positive thinking, law of attraction, there is some truth of that, truth to that. I have experienced that in my life. So it's just a matter of staying positive. Like you said, vibrating at a positive energy. And you know, when we're just getting, like, for myself personally, it seems like there's always something like trying to knock me down and get me, my energy and my emotions off kilter. Just
the matrix, it's honing in on what you're trying to do, and it's going to bombard you with all that negative energy that, you know, life's always throwing us these fucking curveballs out of the blue and stuff, and it's like, what the fuck. And I used to stay in that state of, you know, like, oh, my God, what am I going to do? How are we going to fix this? Where are we going to get the money? It's, you know, it's impossible. It's never going to happen, you know. And my husband would be all cool as a cucumber. Don't worry. It's all going to be fine. Everything's going to work out. And I'm like, what? How can you say that? You know, and, you know, it would work out. So I decided, you know, I'm going to give up on all this negative thinking and just, you know, do what he's doing because it's working for him. Why am I going to waste all my energy worrying about things and crying about things that I have no control over? But actually I do have control over it, because if you stay in that positive mindset and, you know, you don't have the answers, you don't know how something's going to work out, but you know it's going to work out and you're already grateful that it has worked out, you'll see that it'll unfold before you and these things will flow to you and fix the situation, or, you know, things will flow into where they need to be for everything to work out. And then you look back and you think, oh, why did I even do all that worrying? It was such a waste of time. I could have used my time more constructive and stuff like that. And I think things will take longer if you fight it more. You know what I mean? If you stay in that negativity longer, it'll take longer for it to happen. But, you know, if you release that and let it go, it flows to you much more quickly and easily. At least that's what I found.
I'm going to step outside for 1 minute. You guys carry it. I'm not going to go to break because we got to wrap it up in like a half hour. I don't want to take on the break.
Yeah, I'm only going to be over 20 minutes. But before you go, Brian, before you go, remember that residue I sent you on a Coke Zero from Domino's? I'm just ordering some Domino's right now, and now it's changed to Coca-Cola Zero. I'm just looking at their drink menu here.
On the residue you already had at your house or on a new flyer?
No, remember, it was on their website.
Yeah, so it's changed on the website. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I just noticed that as I was ordering.
Give me 2 seconds. You guys take it. I'll be right back, okay? I got like this much of the smoke. Hold on.
So what do you want to talk about, Falker? You got me all to yourself now.
What do I want to talk about? Yeah, you know, I mean, it's just, it's exactly what you're saying. It's trying to navigate, I'm at that realization. We can't defeat this system, whatever it is. It's a matrix. It's just really a matter of understanding that this is physical existence. We're stuck here dealing with this and all the negativity that comes, all the challenges that it's going to present to us to keep us from realizing the potential of our, you know, the soul realizing its purpose. It's not easy, man. It's, you know, it'd be nice if we can all come together. I got a call from, you know, Travis, a plain truth after my last video there. And it was like, he's like, you know what I want to do? I want to like go and film cops, like giving people tickets and do activism, like on the spot. Right. And I'm like, yeah, you know what? It'd be nice, but you know, we can't come together as truthers because I'd like to do that too, but I know I'm going to wind up in jail. But if we get 20 people to do that and be like, listen, you fucking brainless order followers, then we would have some power. And me and him are gung-ho, but he's on the other side there in Maryland, and I'm here on the West Coast. You know what I mean? It's,
yeah.
So coming together, because I had an argument with someone about NPCs and getting along in this world and how I'm just done. I need to kind of distance myself and all, which I can't right now because I'm in, trenched in dealing with public and a lot of people, but it was just sort of like, I can't handle it anymore. I can't dumb myself down to NPC status. And somebody really offended by that, or, you know, an NPC will never understand that they're an NPC, right? You know what I mean? It's like 99.99% of stupid people will never understand they're fucking stupid because they don't know any better, right? They can't see beyond the possibility that they live in. Anyways, what was my point? And then they were like, oh yeah, and where are these people? These like-minded, higher thinking, higher vibrational people that you're talking about. I'm just like, okay, well, you're changing the topic, first of all. That's what NPCs are good at doing. So I decided to answer the question. I go, you know what? The unfortunate reality is we're few and far between. You know what I mean? We're spread out all over the world in all different countries and all different cities and provinces and states. And that's just the way it is. We're surrounded by these soulless NPCs, and we have to figure out how to navigate that. Because it's not in the realm of possibility for us to be like, okay, let's go buy an island and live there. Or let's buy a state, like whatever state we want, like, you know, Montana or Wyoming, wherever it's not populated. You know, let's buy half of Manitoba, something like that. That's not possible. So we have to figure out, I have to figure out, I know for sure, how to navigate in this life amongst these soulless beings. And the thing is, more and more, I can see, like, how they lack soul in my interactions and how my energy. I know the last video I made, for those of you guys that watched it, I was talking about, you know, being repulsed by the NPC energy. But the last week and a half, I really noticed how the NPC energy has an aversion to my energy. You know what I mean? And how isolating and lonely it can be when we want to find like some kind of human interaction, but we can't, because this NPC can sense my, I'll call it organic consciousness, like that channel does, what the fucking Chris and Cherie, you know, like our organic consciousness. It's at that stage right now in 2019, almost 2020, where this NPC mentality has an aversion and can sense it, like kryptonite, and walk away from organic consciousness because they know they're going to get challenged. And once in a while, some of this NPC comes at us just to, like you said, gatekeep, derail us, gaslight us. That's their job, and that's the script that they're running, and that's about all that they can do. Anyways, yeah. So, you know, during this argument, it's like, where are these people? Where are these higher-minded people? Like, you know, you think you're so special. You think you can see something more than, you know, where are these people then? Like, you just can't get along with people, some, you know, and it's kind of like, of course I can't get along with people. People are fucking retarded. I can't dumb myself to the point of being, like, completely unaware of what's going around in my surroundings, right?
Yeah, if the NPCs have their way, we'll be living in the movie Idiocracy. I think we're almost there. and that's scary, especially when people don't care. And, you know, they really should care. And you should care that you don't know these things, and you should be curious. I don't know why they're not curious. I don't know if you know, there's a wide swath of people, and some of us are on one side of the spectrum, some are on the other extreme side of the spectrum, and then there's, you know, the gray area people who just don't know.
Well, I don't think they're wired. I don't think they're wired with this curiosity. They're totally not. And I know a lot of truthers make excuses and say, oh, they'll call them NPCs. You know, at one point we were brainwashed. The difference is we were brainwashed. And when this information was presented to us, something inside of us was like, oh, let me go explore this. The NPC is wired.
We had the spark.
Yeah, the NPC has nothing. They'll glitch out. Mm-hmm. You know, like whatever it is, let me, you know, fuck, I can't think of the example right now, the couple of examples that I had of people completely glitching out. Like, you know, if you're like, okay, well, the curvature, there's no curvature of the earth. Well, the earth is so big. It's huge. You know how big it is? Yeah, I know how big it is. It's 24,901 miles. And then all of a sudden they turn that around to, how do you know that? You're just making that up. Like, you don't know that. You haven't.
How about this, Mac? You must get this, right? They'll do this to me at work. They'll try and poke fun at me about something about flat earth. Well, how does this work? And I'll start to explain something. Oh, I don't care. I don't want to know. Well, why did you ask me then? You asked me thinking I didn't have a fucking answer. And then I started to make a lot of sense. And you get so triggered. And as far as the people glitching out, like I don't know what it is. Are they soulless?
You're really into telling them something and you got their interest for like a split second, and then you could totally tell when you lose them and they glaze over or they just start looking somewhere else. Oh, hey, what's up over there? And you're still talking and you have all these pertinent points you want to throw at them, and they've already left the conversation. They left the building.
That's all they're wired to do, you know?
Yeah.
I had somebody, I was like, oh, is that your car? You know, I'm not going to talk about the situation. I go, yeah, is yours the car the one that's with the decals on? I go, yeah, yeah. You really believe the earth is flat? And I'm like, yeah, I know the spinning ball is a lie. And then, you know, we've been lied to on a massive scale. And then all of a sudden it was like, well, that's what's great about this country. Everybody's entitled to have their own beliefs, and just completely shut me down. And I was like, well, from 2.5 whatever years I've been flat smacking, you know, I've got the wisdom to be like, hey, shut the fuck up. Like, this is a waste of time. Like, you know, that was the programming. Oh, everybody's entitled to their beliefs. Yeah, like it's a belief system. Like, you know, I could have went on and pushed the issue, but I just decided, no, I'm not going to push the issue. It's not going to go anywhere.
The longer we get in this, we're starting to realize it's one of the things I was talking about earlier. We're realizing there's a line in the sand to some people that we just can't waste our energy on. And it's just like, you know what I mean? With that person, where are you going to get with them? Even if you got him to understand some one or two points, it's just eventually he's going to shut down at point number three and just go back. I mean, it's just, you're muted.
You run into them a week later, 2 weeks later. I keep running into a lot of people. I planted so many fucking seeds. I've red-pilled people so many times. I've given them red pills over and over again, but they just can't digest that red pill. That's why I'm convinced that they're NPCs, and it's not any mental thing like cognitive dissonance. Sure, we could talk about it. There's a mental disorder or whatever it's called, cognitive dissonance. But it's not. They just cannot digest the red pill. It just goes fucking right through them, man, or they just spit it out. It's like they're immune to the red pill. That's the way I'll put it. They're immune to it. They have to be their own mentality. I mean, stuck into the script that they're programmed for, you know?
All right, so let me ask you a question. Since we're talking about people glitching out, the update, NPCs, what do you think it is when you're face-to-face, and we all know what happens, so you're face-to-face with somebody, Mac, you bring up Black Tom, let's say. They say, I've never heard of Black Tom. Then you start to explain, and then all of a sudden, they take the update, they start Wikipedia reciting things to you, even though they've never read it. What do you think is the source of that update?
Oh, man, I'd have to speculate.
Oh, yeah, big speculation, but it's something we need to talk about more.
Yeah, I mean, it's okay. One of three possibilities still. You know, I said that a few months ago. It's God there to challenge us in our growth as a spiritual being, or it's Satan who's there to aggravate us and keep us down. right? So God is there to challenge us and make us grow like a cocoon. What is it? A caterpillar coming out of a cocoon, butterfly, that whole thing, right? So it's either God doing that, or it's Satan keeping us down, or it's some kind of AI that is just fucking mind fucking us. You know, those are my speculations on it. I can't think what else it would be.
No, those are good answers. Good answers.
I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, it's some alien race or this or that, or like we're ants and it's some greater intelligence race than us, you know, playing with us and keeping us in a cage. Like, you know, we're fucking around with us like we're some kind of ant. I don't think it's that. So it's one of those three. And I don't know, somebody's saying it's all prophesized. Sure, I mean, it could be all prophesized. It is, but who prophesized it? You know, we don't know where the source of that prophecy. Thanks, Zane.
The software is the best, Flickr. I'm really, like, the chat's on my right-hand side. I just click a message, and it throws it on the screen. I can type whatever I want, throw it on the screen, put the phone number.
Oh, yeah, he can type whatever he wants.
But the thing is, I don't see Zane's comment in the chat.
I think people are so plugged into the Matrix, like in the movie The Matrix, they're not ready to be unplugged, and that's when they start coming up with these excuses and rationalizations for why there's a change, or you know you're misremembering, it was always like that, or I must be misremembering. They'll come up with all these excuses because they can't handle even trying to think about it, because it goes against their reality, their matrix that they're in. And they're not ready to let go of that, to even explore the possibility that something has changed. They will change to acclimate to the change that's happened. And then, you know, we're the ones who are like, you know, realizing the change into the, you know, so for them to be okay with it and still plugged into the matrix, we're the crazy people. You know, I think there's people that are just not meant to see it. And they're so ingrained in the matrix and have been so conditioned that they naturally gatekeep us. And, you know, whether it's written into their script in life or whatever, you know, it's hard to say. That's obviously a speculation. It does seem that way. But, you know, there's just some people who really take into the indoctrination and they can't get out of it. So the only thing that they can do is react to it that way.
Even if they read, so for instance, like my cousin Jason, he's the closest thing I have to a brother. So we grew up with all the same stuff. You know what I mean? So like, for instance, you know what I mean? I could get him with 1,000 fucking Mandela effects, right? But he's so asleep with everything. Like, I know it'll go nowhere. You know what I mean? I can get him to admit to fucking 100 of them, but he's still not going to get it. And he's still just going to accept that it's a psyop or it's a his memory or something, no matter how well I explain it to him. And you know, I can break it down as well as anybody, but he's not going to get it. It's not worth my time. My mother, I will talk to about it. Other people, family members, I will talk to. But him, he believes everything he sees on TV. He got the Trump bumper sticker, the whole fucking thing, dude. You know what I mean?
Well, you observe them. Like, you know, like, honestly, somebody said I'm, like, kind of creepy. Okay, so, like, if I'm observing somebody and really intently looking at someone, no creepy intention. It's, you know, it's kind of like I have to. I'm at that stage where I really have to study people and the way what happens when something is said and how they react to what something is said and what I'm really saying. And I keep going back to, like, it's not a psychological thing that's happening, man. It's something bigger at play here, man. Something bigger at play. It's bizarro world, man.
Yeah, but it's so exciting too. I mean, this is some fucking next level shit. This whole Mandela effect thing and everything that's come down in the last, you know, 5 to 7 years, flat earth and all this stuff. It's just like, wow, this is awesome. I've been waiting for this shit.
I think it's exciting. I love it. It's a ride to the store is crazy because you see changes on the way. I mean, every day on the way to work, I see this residue that I'll show at some point. I got to take a picture of it, but it's just
I mean, so, imagine if in 2012, you know, when we were supposed to wake up the next day, December 21st, 2012, and the Mandela effect hit full steam then instead of now. I mean, it would have been like, wow, yeah, reality shifting, you know, because everybody was waiting for it. Nothing happened. I mean, it happened, but it was happening really small and very gradual. And I remember hearing back then, like in 2011, 2010, leading up to 2012, all those shows that were on and people talking about, you know, your consciousness is going to shift, reality is going to shift, continents are going to shift, all this stuff shifting around. And here we are, 2019, 2020, and shit has shifted. And yeah, I mean,
well, they said in the Bible, I mean, Awaken, I know you're in the chat. He could help us out maybe. In the Bible, they talked about the lands getting closer together and all this shit, I guess.
Yeah.
And you know what's funny is talking about the Bible real quick is you guys all know I haven't read the Bible. You guys all heard what I said earlier. and I'm a guest on Awakened Saints specifically to talk about the Bible on Wednesday morning at 10 a.m. So plug for Awakened Saints channel, 10 a.m. I'll be interviewed by him on the Bible.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, I really like the fact that, you know, you can get somebody to pull out an old Bible, you know, 100-year-old Bible or whatever like that, and, you know, they swear it's going to be one way, and they look at it and find out that, oh, it has, like, you know, it's, you know, that it, sometimes I think face-to-face, they're going to try to save face and be like, oh, well, I must have been mistaken. It's obviously always been like this because, you know, how could this change, you know? But once you leave and walk away from that person's got to be scratching their head being like, holy shit, what the fuck? You know, I know it was always lying and not a fucking wolf. There was never a wolf in that equation anywhere, you know? There was never two people in the car with two women in the car when JFK was shot. I mean, come on. And so, you know, I think a lot of people are closet Mandela affected, you know what I mean? Rational people who don't want to seem crazy and don't really want to put themselves out there. But, I think there's a lot of closet Mandela effect people. I've had people, you know.
I call them cowards.
Well, yeah, you know, at the same time, not everybody's meant to come out like us. It's what I think it is that it's important that we all see it and we recognize it. Not necessarily be voiceful about it, but that we see it. You know what I'm saying? It's not necessarily that we even have to do anything about it or figure out how the hell it's happening, but you have to see it and recognize it and understand and understand that this is happening.
Yeah, okay. I gotta go here in a couple of minutes. I wanted to ask you, Brian. You said Croats talking about Mandela effect before his show he released on Thursday. I heard him talking about it, but where did he talk about Mandela effect? And where's this stream that he did with Richie? I can't find it. I don't know if you
the stream he did with Richie was on Richie's backup, so it's on RFB2.
Okay.
And then, it was about a week ago. And I heard him talking about Lion and the Lamb about a week ago. I can find out for you by tomorrow because
I heard him talking about Lion and the Lamb in his show from Thursday.
And then ask Josh from Oregon is in the chat. Here he is because he's the one that told me about they were talking about Timmy in the Well. There you go. Josh from Oregon knows because Josh from Oregon is the one that told me they were talking about it again.
Oh, you got to be a paid whatever of his.
Yeah, well, I told his buddy Wayne because Wayne's been on my show before way back in the day. We did a show on what's causing the Mandela effect like 2 years ago. And I already told him. I said, you know, if he wants to talk about it, you know who to call. You
know what I mean? Yeah. Well, I've left messages in his chat to get a hold of you as a guest to talk Mandela effect. So maybe that's coming. That's coming.
Yeah, I'm sure you're not the only one. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that'll be good. More people, you know, I'm getting everybody looking at it, and you see it. I know you see it.
I'm popping in
channels, popping in Zulu's channel, just taking over the show for like 3 hours a night.
Oh yeah, and like you're asking them questions and stuff, like they're on your show.
Right on. Okay, I'm going to take off. And, you know, I was driving through the forest and all that, and I said in my video, Smokey the Bear. Like, you know, that's huge. Like, anyway, yeah. We could go on and I could talk about all of these Mandela effects. Something has changed, man. And, wake the fuck up. Like, but you can't wake people up. Like, I don't know. I don't know if there's closet Mandela affected people, man. I don't know. I don't see it, but most of them, I believe it's flatter. But anyways, peace out. I got to run. The Domino's is going to close. I need to get some crappy food before I go to bed.
Oh, yeah. That's seriously crappy corporate food.
I know. What do, man, living out here? There's nothing open. Nothing healthy is open this late at night. It's just fine.
Go eat some dandelions. They're good for you.
No, there's no. You know what? Funny thing is, I haven't seen dandelions all summer.
You know, I haven't either, and I usually have them all over my lawn. That's very strange, and they are really, really good for us. They have us mowing them off our grass, and, you know, their weeds get rid of them, but they actually have a lot of healing properties for the body. So it's no big surprise that they have us mowing them down and calling them weeds and trying to get rid of them.
Was that a Mandela effect maybe that they disappeared, or you think it's all the spraying and
I don't know. We've had such a bizarre summer. It was like we went from spring, which was barely nothing, to straight into 95, hot and humid ever since mid-April, end of April, straight on. It's still like I haven't even laid out once yet this summer because it's been too fucking hot and humid. It's just, I've never had such oppressive hot, humid heat hangover for months on end. It's just like I can't even wait for winter time now, and I am not a winter person.
Wow. No, I want more heat. Bring on more heat. Ugh. Anyways, I'm gonna take off. I'll be listening while I drive home. Thank you guys for having me on, and we'll chat soon. And
right,
give Zane a wrench, for God's sake. How do I eject myself? I did. Oh, leave.
Eject.
Fuck out, bitch.
He's ejecting. Ejecting all over the place.
If I didn't have to work in the morning, I could keep going for a while.
Yeah, I don't have to work tomorrow. I'm off all week. It's a rare occurrence.
How did you manage that?
I didn't manage it. My manager managed it. I looked at I worked 11 days straight. And so, yeah, I'm okay with being off all week. It's just the way the business that I'm in goes. You have these busy times, and then you have these slow times. And this is kind of one of them. So I'm all right with it. So is anybody else going to call in? Am I getting any more calls? Is the phone still open?
The phone, I shut it. No, the phone is open. All right, yeah. If anybody wants to call in, we could take one, maybe two more calls. 978-435-0006. I'll put it up on the screen. There you go.
I think we should do a video, or excuse me, we should do one show, though, of all the tech before its time stuff. And Lone Eagle did really good research on tech before its time. I think Noblest D did a lot of stuff with tech before its time, some of his research. And I want to, like, you know, we should present a bunch of stuff because people hear us talk about it, but I don't know if anybody's actually, you know, went through it one by one, but it's really interesting stuff. The 1800s is just all kinds of stuff was being invented and all kinds of things were going on in the 1800s, where before it was like nothing was going on, barely anything.
Yeah.
You get into like the latter half of the 1800s and it's like modern times, no problem. They probably had internet now. It's crazy stuff.
It is crazy. And this place we live in is super shifty.
Yeah. Now, like, even with that whole Tatarian thing and that popping up in the history and the map changes and stuff, this is takes us back to, you know, they're hiding more land. There's, you know, these borders that they put on all these countries and stuff. Nothing's what we think it is. And we only have what they've given us to go by. I don't know what the shapes are of these continents. I'm going by what I learned in the textbook and that big ball globe thing that they shoved up our asses all fucking 12 years of our lives. Yeah, I think there's definitely more land and possibly more people, but I think there's more land, there's more everything, whether it's outside of our perimeter or what. But, you know, look at the Pacific Ocean. If that's as massive as they portray it to be, there could be a whole fucking continent over there that nobody knows about.
Yeah, that's what I've been saying.
Yeah, I mean, it's huge. And they know all this shit. They know what's on the other side of the ice wall or in the dome. They know They just know it all. They know what it's made out of, how big it is, how what the expanse is of it. They know all this fucking shit. And they know all about us being able to manifest, especially during this time right now. And they're doing their damnedest to keep us disconnected from that and disconnected from each other and disconnected from our senses. I mean, people don't even trust their senses, their eyes, what's right in front of their eyes. They don't even trust it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna
wind it down because I do.
All right. Sounds good. Thank you.
5:07 for work.
Thank you, Carla.
Make sure you sub Jen's channel. Her link's right on the screen. It's very easy. Her YouTube name is The Truth Seeker 69. Also, make sure you subbed and bell to all three of my channels. This isn't even my main, if you didn't know that. This is my backup, but right now I'm doing all my shows in my backup. But all, you know, so just make sure you subbed and bell to all three, because in another day or so, I'll be able to go live on the Dose of Reality Show channel again. That 1 week ban, because I got hit on hate speech on that too last week. So I'll do a live show over there just to kind of keep all the channels lively. And I'll probably do my very next show will be on the Dose of Reality Show channel live. So make sure you guys sub and bell Jen. I have to go. I have to work in the morning. So
all right. Well, thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, everybody. I am out of here.
Bye, guys.